Good morning to everyone. It is my great pleasure to welcome everyone to webinar on NAAC in NAAC revised accreditation framework. National Assessment and Accreditation Council is an organization that assess and accredits higher education institutions in India. It is an autonomous body funded by University Grant Commission, Government of India, headquarters in Bangalore. NAAC was established in 1994 in response to recommendations of national policy in education. This policy was to address the issues of deterioration in quality of education and the program of action. Laid out the strategic plan for the policy, including the establishment of an independent and national accreditation body. NAAC certification is a measure to evaluate and then guarantee a standard of education provided in higher institutions across the nation. Education is required by every nation for its development. As a result, the excellency and relevance of the program offered by the universities must have a standard. As a every arena of the business, the method of improving the quality as a predetermined defined set of methods. University or colleges must find and recognize additional requirements to satisfy them as per the international standards. NAAC accreditation was created to be every institution to stand on the same ground of to perform the best. So on this moment, I would like to heartily welcome to our Honorable Vice Chancellor and Professor Karishita Pasar on this moment. And warm welcome our Register Dr. Anand Deshpandesar and Register of Evaluation Professor Satish Pandigeri sir on this moment. It is my pleasure to welcome today resource person Dr. Nagalingappa, distinguished professor and mentor Silver Line Education, Davangere. Sir, thank you for coming, sir. And also welcome our regional director, Dr. K. Manjunath sir, Mysore region. And MBA department chairman, Dr. Basavaraj Kuttimad sir, Vishwasya Technological University, Belaga. Coordinator of this webinar, Dr. Etish Chandra, associate professor, department of MBA, Mysore. And Dr. Kavita, assistant professor, and all program coordinators of different departments, all participation of various universities and colleges from all over India. Once again, welcome you all. Once again, thank you very much.
I'm here to introduce the distinguished professor, Professor Nagalingappa sir. I would like to remember my old association with Professor since 15 years. We have been associated in the academic activities during the programs of Karnataka State Open University. So it gives me a privilege to introduce him. Professor Nagalingappa sir has done his BE in Mechanical Engineering, MBA in Marketing, and he has completed his PhD in Management on the topic of Business Process Reengineering, which is one of the quality initiatives for corporate quality management and tools to improve competencies of Indian industries. He has a lot of certifications and proficiency. He is a certified strategic management teacher, certified after attending a series of courses on strategic management conducted by all the IIMs, XLRI, MDI, and IIFT. Sir is also a certified ISO lead auditor trained by Legal Bar and Associates and TUV India. He is also a certified ZEB consultant by Government of India, conducted by QCI New Delhi, to do so consulting for MSME to be certified by Z and the Make in India program. Sir is a trainer, the trainer program sponsored by Department of International Development, DFID, UK, British Government partnership with AASC, and delivered by the Science, Engineering, Manufacturing and Technology Alliance Centre of UK as knowledge partner, conducted by trainers of Dublin, UK. He has also conducted a postdoctoral study on international high technology business partnership project on business practices of leading high technology firms in India with California State, Fullerton State University, USA. He has professional co-curricular or extracurricular activities like, to name few. He is the founder chairman of and CEO of Dr. Engie's Academy for Competitive Exams. He has got awarded 3 PhD research scholars in the BTU. He has also served as chairman of Board of Studies, Management Studies, and the PhD Registration Committee of MBA in BTU. He is also an independent director on board of Cadillacs Ahmedabad. He has got rich corporate experience at middle and top level management in various industries. He has traveled widely abroad in to name a few countries like USA, UK, Europe and Middle East, to name a few. He has also published and presented papers in national and international repute, seminars and chaired many sessions at various international conferences. He's got an impeccable teaching and guiding experience of postgraduate students in India and abroad, like Indiana University of Pennsylvania, USA. Sir has also been awarded the Gold National Award and a doctoral, doctorate in management, having collective experience of more than 32 years in industry and academics. He is a highly resourced person for in the area of management and quality management. He has handled numerous consulting assignments such as management and technology consultant to various organizations. I would like to mention here, he has been a NAC consultant for various universities and institutions like Tirthankar University, Moradabad, which could get B grade, BNMIT at Bangalore, got A++, which was the credit to, and the credit goes to Professor Nagalinga Basal in getting A++. AIT in Chikmagalore, GMIT, Davangere, Dayanand Sagar in Bangalore, New Horizon College of Engineering in Bangalore, to name few. And he was the one who initiated this consultant process at PESIT, wherein the benchmark for benchmarking, he had visited UK, Oxford and Cambridge University, and Harvard and Stanford University in USA. And in the wake of the National New Education Policy of 2020, NAC finds its significant place and a role in developing organizations to provide quality education. Hence, we are very happy to have you as a resource person, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Now I request Professor Nagalinga Prasad to take over and conduct the webinar. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Screen is good. Mic.
Good morning to all of you. I take this opportunity to thank authorities at VTU and in particular Professor Renuka Murthy to give me this opportunity. Their unique experience, COVID-19 has brought a unique experience. Here are the faculty at VTU Regional Center Mysore. They are off, they are on, and I have given understanding that around 550 of web people are on web. So let us see and make this most interesting. The first is, if you look at my first slide, is on workshop on. Okay, am I audible? Am I audible? Am I okay with my voice?
Yes sir, you are audible.
Okay, fine. It is basically a workshop. Due to the different mode of conversation, things may go here and there. Let us take the benefit of COVID-19 and technology. If you look at the slide here, I have taken this nature, the bunch of grapes. It talks about, you know, if you look at the bottom portion of the grapes, it is almost in young ones. Clarity, I don't know about it. And if you look at little other way, it is the grapes are ripe or ripened.
Slide is not visible, sir.
Yeah, PPT is not visible.
So look at the can you see this? Yeah, this is how the nature itself is binding. Yes. Together, nature has taught us how to be together. So therefore, any organization will have youngsters, experienced, and all that. Particularly systems like this, you need both youngsters and the experienced ones. So what I thought of is, you know, everybody is aware, around 550 people are on webinar now. So I thought that, you know, most of you are already in the process of doing things. So I want to only talk about only nuances in the revised accreditation framework. Particularly, it has come after 2017, and the institutions that are going now, they are on that place. The thing is, timing is from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Those present in VTU Regional Center, I request them to workshop etiquettes like, you know, off mode or silent mode, and please be seated in your designated places. What is that revised? Those who are already done first cycle, second cycle, third cycle, they know about the entire qualitative method and quantitative method, how things were going on in the use book like thing. In particular, this particular revised accreditation framework is a paradigm shift has taken place. So basically, extensive use of ICT, information communication technology, which enables us to be very, very objective, very transparent, scalable, and robust. This is the first paradigm shift between the old one and revised accreditation one. This shift is for a qualitative judgment of data based on quantitative indicator evaluation. So RAF is in terms of increased objectivity and transparency towards extensive use of ICT, confirming scalability, robustness in terms of specifications of the process, drastic reduction in number of questions. The old one has a lot of questions. Now they are seems to be redundant. Example. Number of questions, size of the report, visit days. Earlier, a normal hard copy, bound copy, which submit about 450 to 500 pages, and in multiple copies. Now that has come down. Of course, zero it is. Now it is all system based. Next is visit days have come down because most of the system is done by using ICT in place. So therefore, now it is 1.5 days, 2 days. Earlier it used to be 0 day followed by 3 days, just to be very, very cumbersome. In terms of boosting benchmarking, this particular RAF has taken an attempt has been made to take the indicators, national and international quality frameworks. So therefore, the new education policy also may help by doing taking few of things from here. So it means we're in the right direction. Introducing pre-qualifier. There was no pre-qualifier earlier. Whoever the whatever the HEI, Higher Education Institute, to submit, there is to pair team visit. In this case, you need to qualify. By the time you submit your data, 25% of the system generated scores are done. So therefore, you will know that whether you're eligible or not, whether you are eligible to go for pre-qualifier or not. Next is, most of it is done through system based. About 70% of it is done through system generated score. Therefore, human judgment is now taken out. So therefore, your data feeding at the time of filling up the forms is going to be key important issue. And that judgment is given only for 30%, that too while a pair team visiting the institutions. Then the difference is matrices here and weightages and benchmarking of, clearly they brought out what should be in universities, what should be in autonomous institutions, and what should be in constituents or affiliated colleges. So therefore, grading becomes more appropriate. Earlier, it was one system used for everything. Now it is changed. And revising several matrices to bring the enhanced participation. This is very key important here. We're talking about stakeholders. Stakeholders could be students, alumni, then professors, university, all that. So involvement of students and alumni is going to be the key issue here. Their role is a very dominant role in revised accreditation framework. If you look at a number of criteria, key indicators, and quantitative and qualitative metrics, if you look at it, this remains same for all of them. There are 7 criteria. I think criteria, everyone know about it. Then key indicators, 34, 34. In case of UG, it is 31. In case of PG, it is 32. When I go in depth, I'll also talk about which are those with minus, which are those plus. And qualitative metrics, you have 36 for university and 35 for autonomous. There's one minus there. 35 for UG programs and 36 for PG programs. In case of quantitative metrics, 79 of them from the university, and autonomous college will have only 72, and UG 58, and PG 60. This particular slide is going to be the key factor for everybody. Based on this, you're going to fill up your entire SSR. Therefore, university, now we're talking about university, VTU, 115 is total number of weightages or qualitative metrics you need to adhere to. What are those? Next. Now, today's outcome of the workshop could be ICT-based accreditation by NAC. So you have to understand that basically. Understanding revised accreditation framework. Understanding outcome-based education. I will touch upon a small amount on outcome-based education at program level and course level. Because it's an university, they need to be ahead of issues. Understanding revised Bloom's taxonomy. I think this is very, very appropriate, keeping in tune with all HEIs and their qualitative initiatives. I think they are introduced, but I don't know whether you heard about it. My competency is involved in accreditation process since 20 years, trained more than 3,000 teachers in accreditation process across country, addressed more than 8,000 students, consultant for 8 engineering colleges and an university, and I have trained by STEMA, that is UK, Dudley College, UK. Because 550 people are on webinar, I deemed it is appropriate to talk about what is in it for me? Why should they go for accreditation? It assures quality and effectiveness of organization, helps institution in admissions, quality student intakes. Now, COVID is in place. People are, our parents, our students are looking for which is the best university for my career, progress, our studies. Therefore, if your quality system will help you, whether the institutions are graded with A++, A+, A or B, So the students or parents are now looking for a better college for them to study. So therefore, admission is going to be the key factor. Then next is, competition is very high. We'll also take good intake. Intake also goes up because only competitive students will get into your institute. Therefore, teaching goes very good. Then comes the result. Then comes the placement. Ultimately, parents ask about placement. Helps institution in placements. Next is that, why my child should be in any particular institute is because of its, you know, the institute's reputation plus institute's serious about the system in place. Accreditation is must for institution which are going for autonomous. Next is getting funding and grants, because we know that one need to be getting a lot of funds and grants from various agencies. I'll also talk about which are the various agencies available, where professors, teachers across the university, autonomous institutions and other affiliated or constituent college must try for funds and grants, because fee going to be the very, very key issue. Therefore, only way to move our research and other things is through funding and grants. Next is international recognitions. Now, this new education initiatives in place, government is looking for or planning for tie-ups with international universities and other things, where international recognition is going to be a key issue in future. There are two quotes which I always love to share, is that if you want to do something new, you have to stop doing something old. This is Peter Drucker. I think management people who are aware there about it. Next is Albert Einstein's, if you always do what you always did, you always will get what you always got it. I think there are two things. If you want to go ahead, you need to do something new. Something new at this moment for VTU is, how can you get best grade available? The small quiz, it is there, faculty available here, they're in the verge of filling up the SSR. Others also can take up this. Can you expand NAC? What is that? National Accreditation Assessment Council. Okay. How many criteria are there in NAC?
Seven criteria.
Very good. Seven. Very good. Total marks for evaluation?
200.
Okay. Any guess? Any more guess? Total mark for evaluation, how many? Good. It is 1,000. Okay. 1,000
marks. Thank you.
1,000 marks. Okay. Who and when to go for accreditation? Which are the higher education, HEIs? Which are the HEIs can go for accreditation?
Autonomous institutions.
Okay. Next. Is not right answer. Still, I'll give you a bonus point. Next. The institution which has got at least two batches must have been passed out. Okay. Suppose if it is engineering college, four years of engineering degree plus two batch, it means 6 years. If it is a graduation degree for 3 years, 3 years plus 2 years, 5 years. If it is Bachelor of Veterinary Science, or if it is a Bachelor of Agriculture Science, if it is a Medical Science, so therefore, degree plus two batch must have been passed out. Is it clear, sir?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Why should institution go for NAC? I think previous slide I explained, right?
International recognition.
Okay, good. There's one.
Admission and placement.
Yes, correct.
For funding and grants.
Funding and getting grant, funding and grant, correct.
To go for autonomous status.
Yeah, institutions which are not in autonomous status, they can go for autonomous status, correct.
For placements and all.
Yes, for better placement. Because if an institute is accredited, companies also will look for accredited institutions like IBM or TCS or Infosys, like that, okay?
Yeah.
Is your institution accredited?
Yes.
Depend upon yes, no, okay? If yes, which cycle and when it goes, when it expires, are you aware of this? People participating, you can have it, okay?
Yes.
Okay. One more question. Infrastructure and learning resources in which criterion?
Four.
Correct. Can I have your name, please?
Dr. A. Madhuprasad.
Which institution affiliation?
INADA Janayama College, Autonomous Sivasi, Madurai Kamaraj University.
Oh, very nice. You are right. It is in four. Which cycle are you in now?
Fourth cycle completed, sir.
Fourth cycle. Oh, you are grand old master you are then. Okay, good.
Thank
NAC headquarters is in which city?
Bangalore.
Ahmedabad.
Bangalore, fine. What is SRA?
Bangalore. Sir.
What is SRA? Any idea? Any guess? I'll give a guess.
Self-assessment report.
Self-assessment report. No, no. Anything else? Good, good. This is here. If you look at the revised accreditation framework, there is one slide on this. It is called as statutory and regulatory. Hello? Yeah.
Authority.
You got the point? No? Statutory. What is statutory? And regulatory.
Norms.
Yes.
Norms framed by MAC.
Okay. Some I can give you some bonus point. But exactly, statutory and regulatory agency, for example, statutory means it is a respective government, okay, the state government and their universities, like Tamil Nadu government and your Madurai Kamraj University, like that. In case of regulatory, it could be like AICT, it could be like a Pharmacy Council of India, it could be Medical Council of India, it could be any councils that they are called as regulatory agencies. Okay, while we fill up the SSR, while we do the SSR or while we go for NAC accreditation, it is mandatory that you fulfill all the requirements of statutory as well as regulatory agencies. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, nice.
Yes.
Okay. There are videos, but technology issue. Now the answer for the third question there, all higher education institutions, including universities, deemed to be universities, autonomous and non-autonomous colleges, they have completed 6 years of or 2 batches must have been passed out. I think this is very clear. So those who are planning, they can plan for this. Key issues, some of this key snapshot would be, when did this was established in 1984 NAC? It is under UGC. Its administration is autonomous because they are governing council, the director is headed, this institute is headed by a director and he has a governing council like that. Supervising authority is MHRD, Government of India. Scope is all streams will come under this, whether it could be a degree college, it could be arts, science, engineering, technology, management, all will come in this. Medical units of assessment, it is university, institution and college. It is as a whole. Those who are in knowing about NBA, National Board for Accreditation, they do for programs. In this case, it is a university or institution or a college as a unit, all it is. The validity period is for 5 years cycle, it is 5 years. Okay. And the process when compared to any other system, it bit simple it is. Grading pattern, you have CGPA pattern, followed by A++, A+, A, B++, B+, B, C and D, D is not accredited. So we should plan somewhere above this. Documentation, you have IIQA, then SSR, then DVV, and triple S. These are the 4 stages of documentation. Okay, this is about the fee details and other things, which varies from college to college, university to university.
Can you log on to the website
and go through the website and do that. Look at the process. There are 5 processes. Institutional information for quality assessment, IIQA. Earlier it is to be called or something like LOI, letter of intent, the earlier it was. Now it is IIQA because it is ICT enabled one. And self-study report, it continues to be self-study report. Next is NAC has hired an outside agency to do what? Data validation and verification, DVV, and pre-qualifier scores. They do that pre-qualifier, then only you're eligible to upload your SSR. Further peer team visit, committee visit to a institution. The key factor, because students are one of the stakeholders. There are many stakeholders. Students are the prime. Students, alumni, professors, university, and then suppliers like that. So therefore, student satisfaction survey is more important here, because 10% of the survey has to be the total number you uploaded. Then only it will count for the peer team visit. On-site assessment, peer team visit committee will come, depend on the size of the unit, that may be university, college, like that, types of expertise. There are many issues on that. That is also done through random based, because database available in their data system, so it will randomly pick the assessor now. Then final decision is by NAC, all the data put together, then they do that, then they will have a committee meeting, usually whatever the colleges have been inspected or a peer team visit is over, during end of that month they have the meeting and then they decide, they put the final decision. It can be seen on website now. So look at what are the 7 criteria available: curricular aspects, teaching, learning and evaluation, research, innovation and extension, infrastructure and learning resources, student support and progression, governance, leadership and management, institutional values and best practices. Why I do this repetition is 450 of them have enrolled today's webinar. Therefore, somebody could be a learner. Somebody like Madurai Kamaraj University has gone for 4 times. So those who know it, kindly bear with me. Why should we? Where do we get money? You assess yourself. Strength and weakness. You assess yourself. Where do you stand? What are my strengths? What are my weaknesses? Therefore, you take up, you just work on these weaknesses. Definitely, you're going to convert your institutions in a better manner by converting them or minimizing weaknesses. Next is where all you can get financial assistance. You can get through UGC. You can get through AACT. You can get CSIR. You can get DST and lot many other universities. They have got their very governments have declared a lot of funding for higher learning. And it can be used for infrastructure development, laboratories, then sports facilities, extension of hostel facilities, and to procure teaching aids. So these are a few of the funding agencies who focus on these. And faculty member also will have a lot of, activity to go on other than teaching, because criteria talks about research and other things. Avail funding assistance for major and minor research work. There another area where everybody need to do is research. Next is institution can conduct workshops, conferences by using fund available by various agency. As far as I know, VTU has funded a lot of fund for conducting workshops and conferences and seminars in its constituent college as well as its affiliated colleges. And they also, to an extent, sponsored travel expenditure too. This is how the stages of accreditation process, that is IIQA, DVV, SSS, and on-site assessment. Of course, these are all available on the web for the benefit of others. Just I put it here, but you can go through in detail. I'm interested to more on talking about key issues in how to do that documentation. This I have already talked about, percentage I talked about. Now let us look at very keenly here, because earlier they said 200 marks. This is about 1000 marks or weightages, how it is divided. If you know this, then you will be very clear how to do that. Curricular aspect, university 150 marks or weightage, this is called weightages. Teaching and learning is 200. Research and innovation and extension activity. See, I am in today VTU's regional office. They are also going for NAC accreditation, 250 marks. So this is very, very key component here. Infrastructure and learning resource, 100. Student support and progression is 100 marks. Governance, leadership and management, 100. Then institutional values and best practices is 100. So this is how it makes 1000. In case of affiliated colleges, autonomous colleges, kindly look at this. Those who are already participants are there. Here, teaching becomes the great or more component for you. So therefore, it is 300 here, and affiliated college, it is 350. Because the syllabus is given by or supplied by university, therefore, you have a great role to deliver education delivery mechanism. We say you are great. You have to do a lot of things here. In case of research innovation, university has to do a lot here, because they are an higher learning slab they have to do. In case of autonomous college, it is only 150, and in case of affiliated college, it is 120. Research component is reduced here a lot. Sorry. Look at this is all called key indicators. These are all the key indicators. Every criterion has got key indicators. They are amounting to 34. You have to focus on these key indicators. The coordinators for these, please note, those who are in criteria 1 coordinator must note this, must master on this, in fact. University Curricular Design and Development 50. Next is Curriculum Planning and Implementation. University is not coming into this. Autonomous is not getting into this. Affiliated colleges, because you know, syllabus is supplied by university. Therefore, the education delivery mechanism becomes the prime important here. Academic flexibility. University has a lot of academic flexibility. Autonomous also has got, but in case of affiliated, it is stringent because you have to form the norms of the university. However, it is not limited. However, you can also do lot of academic flexibility courses. When it comes, I will also explain you what kind of courses you can do. How can you make your student employable? Because there is nowhere it is mentioned how should you make your students employable. Therefore, you must design such a manner that how can be flexible, how can be making your students employable. Curriculum enrichment, in case of university is 30, in case of autonomous is 40, because they can do quickly things because their board and board of studies, everything is in autonomous institution is done in their rather purview, and they can, their structure is very lean, they can do it much faster. In case of university, it takes time because it has own system. Feedback 2020. So what kind of feedback? Other thing I would like to explain. In case of curriculum design process and development, I'm talking about university now. University has a well-developed structure called BOS, BOE like that, or academic council. BOS, BOE members and minutes of meeting. Here, what you need to do while at the time of uploading data, when did you conduct or when did the feedback mechanism, when did you take the last feedback? Feedback from, it could be from the individuals, feedback from the constituent college, feedback from the affiliated colleges. The chairman BOS or BOE will receive some feedback from institutions. It could be feedback from the teaching staff or from parents or from the students also. And then how do they, while conducting BOS and BOE, they undergo certain types of meetings. All that minutes of the meeting to be recorded properly, because it is one of the things we have to apply. When did you have the last meeting? What is the percentage of change in your syllabus when compared to the previous one? You should be able to mark it. Because year on year, your syllabus has to be updated, because they need to take a lot of input from the industry. For example, computer science in engineering, they just go on and talk about what exactly industry needs, because that is now industry also will keep giving you a lot of inputs, what kind of syllabus they need to be incorporated in syllabus. Next is, I think now everybody has gone for CBCS, that is a choice-based credit system. So here I would like to spend a minute or so. What is credit? The credit is one contact hour per week. Therefore, while you design your syllabi, you need to look into the matter here. How many should be 4 credit or 3 credit or 4 credit courses? And how many should be 1 credit or 2 credit courses? If you look at the new education policy, which talks about 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4, it comes in picture here. Then do your syllabi has exit plan? There has to be exit plan. So therefore, there is no question of dropouts. So therefore, choice-based credit system. The student can choose one. Some are mandatory courses or programs, courses, and others could be choice. Can they move their credits to the main certification? So there are issues here. So many universities are in place, many autonomous colleges, they are well placed and they are doing good, but others have to do a lot here in tune with the foreign university or in tune with our competitors. Next is your syllabi or is included cross-cutting issues integrated into curriculum? Is an issue. There are a lot of cross-cutting issues. One is we just teach as a passing remark, that is not enough. Can there be issues which can be in the credit form or in terms of non-credit form also? Next is additional inputs in the form of guest lectures, because syllabi, when it is framed, it has, suppose engineering syllabus will go for 4 years and MBA syllabus will go for 2 years. There could be a lot changes in the meantime. How can we fill? Because teacher may not have entire competency to teach the entire subject. I do teach at Indiana University of Pennsylvania or other universities abroad, where a particular a syllabi can be done or a course can be taught by 2-3 persons. I may be having, let us say, 30% in-depth knowledge on that. Some my colleague may have this. We do collaborative teaching, so all such teachings are there. But in India, yet to come all this, you have to appreciate now onwards. So to fill those gaps, what you should do, you invite guest lecturer from industry or person who is competent in that particular thing. Industry, because they do practices, especially software people. Example, when it was only C++, then C++ came, now IoT came, artificial intelligence came, then machine learning has come. So a lot of things. Therefore, you need to call an industry person, and then can you make your students learn? Therefore, they're employable. At the end of the day, who are our customers? As an institution, my immediate customer is, there are two types of customer basically. One is internal customer, other one is external customer. My internal customer for me is my student. Therefore, is he equipped with lot of knowledge? Therefore, he can be employable. Next is, can you conduct some workshops? Because syllabus may be new, sometimes the teachers may not have the competency. This can be filled through conducting workshops. Could be ranging from 2 days to 3 days or 1 day, whatever, depend upon the course. Next is, can you conduct some symposiums? Ultimately, you're making your students employable. I am stressing on this, I may be repeating, but your key issue as a teacher is that, can I make my student employable? All our effort should be that we must make our student employable. Next is, can you consult with other academicians who are expert? All knowledge may not be available with 1, 2, 3. Can we go get into, suppose an VTU can, VTU teachers, can they consult IIMs? Can they consult IITs? There are some experts available, because there are a lot of experts available in those higher learning institutions or some industries or some centers like DRDO or could be HAL or some other agencies. Okay, industry, employment sector, and alumni. You need to talk to these guys. Ultimately, these people who dictate us that we need these things. I think now many institutions are already in tune with this. I agree with this, in tune with this. Some of the institutions who have got alumni is very strong alumni, they keep giving feedback to institutions. Industry is looking for a particular thing, then why don't you incorporate in this? If it is not possible to incorporate in the syllabus method, you can also do extra. Next is student attributes. Very, very important here it is. Now the whole world is our marketplace. Earlier it was limited to a regional or a nation. Now it is international. So therefore, my student who passed out from my institute may take up a job in abroad. Therefore, these things do he easy has. How practical he is? How good he is at practicals? Do he has soft skills? I remember saying, getting into industry is a beginning, but holding your job in place is your skill, soft skill. So I think most of the institutions talk about soft skills. If you look at it ACT perspective in engineering colleges, where the first semester they have a lot of things to do with soft skills. Then can you do some PDP, personality development program, for students? Can we tune them? Can we make them useful? Because our students could come up from different places. Somebody could be metros, somebody could be village, somebody could be semi-rural. Can you tell them that what is their personality? You can use any instruments here to do this PDP. You can do instruments, assess them in the beginning itself and tell them their strengths and weakness. Therefore, by the time he pass out from your course, he is well equipped with the tools and techniques so that he can be competent in facing interview, and then he can get a better placement. Then interdisciplinary courses. I think this is where you talk about, if you look at new education policy, they talk a lot on interdisciplinary courses. I leave it here because this itself is a big topic. What are the interdisciplinary courses? How can we do that? What should be administered? I know one institute in the US where I do teach, the animal husbandry students, they take management course. Our sports management course students, they take management course. So therefore, the management course could be required for everybody. However, their programs also, now they introduce all those courses. But look at carefully on these interdisciplinary courses. Then, how good are they in assignments? the assignment should be challenging assignments. By use Bloom's taxonomy here, for doing this. And most of the students' nature is that they copy and submit assignment. Can you make slightly different? So therefore, this is a challenging year. Then can you conduct some quizzes, surprise tests, quizzes, so that students are alert in the class when you deliver class mechanism, where education delivery mechanism, do some quizzes, one or two quizzes in the class, so that every student is alert in the class. Next, number of programs option leading to different degrees, diplomas, certifications. Here, those who are now on the program, those, I think MOOC, you know about it, Massive Open Online Courses, you know, NPTEL, National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning, and COVID has really made us to learn a lot of new things. I think most of my colleagues who are in teaching, they're already doing with LMS, Learning Management System. I had happened to visit one of the primary school to know how they are delivering this mechanism in COVID system. I really appreciate them by using technology available with them by mobile, and they are really doing a wonderful job. Though their classes may be ranging from 10 to 15 minutes, but what need to be conveyed to student is conveyed. Absolutely, they convey that. And teachers now need, because it can be watched by parents, it can be watched by other teacher in other institution, it can be watched by parents. Therefore, teacher need to be more accurate now. Because is, you know, for my program, I give an understanding that around 550 of you are logged on. I don't know, somebody may be knowing much better than me, but I need to be more competent in talking to you guys. I hope you appreciate that. Feedback system on curriculum from students, alumni, and faculty members. When I talked about BOS chairman, he need to consider people write about the curriculum. When curriculum is given to the universities or institutions, they also request the feedback. When they upload in their website, they ask from the parents, they ask from students, they ask from industry, and they ask from alumni. So while you frame the new syllabus, you need to take up this feedback. There are three types of feedback need to be taken. That is, one is on the infrastructure, second is on syllabus, third is on teacher. So therefore, where are you going to get this format for this? Those who are not aware of this, you go to the university UGC website, you get a lot of formats available on that. And you can make your own, feedback form, which suits you. Let us get into the second criteria, teaching, learning, and evaluation. So those who are going for, particularly I'm in the VTU staff here, they are also attending online, offline, both they are there. Kindly look at this, because they're going to be marks here. Student enrollment and profile, 10 marks. Because anyway, your student, your university, you get better student because of a lot of issues there. Okay. So therefore, 10 marks for you. Look at autonomous and affiliated, 30, because they need to attract better students and profile. Profile includes a lot of, I'll come to that in detail. Catering to student diversity, 20 marks. Teaching learning process. Teacher profile and quality, 50 marks university, and others are 60 and 80 here. Because while at the time of recruitment, affiliated colleges must give emphasis to well-qualified PhD professors, well-qualified and who has written books, who has done a lot of work in research, who is very competent in teaching. All these things will matter here, because 80 marks here. Evaluation and process, because university, anyway, it is most of them are government in nature. So therefore, they follow certain system in while recruiting. Evaluation process and reforms, 40 is more important. I think VTU is tuned up this. I think one, as I know, I'm with the VTU for last 20 years, since 99 onwards. University has done lot on this evaluation process. I think I can appreciate this. This is the best process available as I know. There may be best process available elsewhere, but as far as I know, that VTU has done wonderful things in here. There are a lot of things. I'll come to that. I'll do that. Student performance and learning outcomes, 30. I think most of them are already in OBE method now. Student satisfaction survey, 30 marks here. Others are 50. Assessment of learning levels of students. Now you need to look at RBT, Revised Bloom's Taxonomy, and feedback matters a lot here. Earlier we thought teaching primary school students, you need either D.Ed, B.Ed, like that. Now, B.Ed is for 2 years. For teaching postgraduate students, you don't need any of the certifications. However, now, revised Bloom's taxonomy is ruling a roost. Therefore, teachers of higher learning institutions, now they cannot have any excuse. They need to go through the RBT, learn yourself. Everything is available in web. Whatever my program, my slides also, I have taken it from web only, and I am sharing my 20 years of experience in this. Okay, you need to be master here. Revised Bloom's taxonomy, you need to be master. Because it also sets for question paper setting, how the questions to be, I'll also touch a slide on that. Next is statement of attainments with respect to POs, PSOs, COs, and question paper pattern a lot here. If you look at the old method, where you used to write, used to give 5 questions, answer 3, that kind of thing, or short question like that. But now a lot of changes have come in. You have to map them. In case of those institution, engineering institution which are going for MBA, they are thorough with this because they need to map it. Which is mapping, where is the shortfall, how to improve upon them, the whole course, Y-1, all that come into picture here. Student-centric methods for enhanced learning experiences. Now, if you look at everywhere, they talk about learning experience. What is that learning experience? How can you make student learning student-centric? Earlier, it was teacher-centric. Teacher is to tell that, I know everything, kindly listen to me, or listen to me. Now, it is not so, because equal knowledge is available to students as well as to teachers. Some of the students may be much, much ahead of you. They must have read and come to the class. Therefore, the entire teaching methodology has to change now. Earlier case, come and spend an hour or
excuse
so and
me,
go
sir.
Off without even knowing what is happening.
Whether they are excuse me, sir.
Now, you need to change methodology.
Excuse me, sir.
Did my student learn things? If you have learned, how much you have learned? Then comes orientation program and induction program. I'll ask a question here. What is the difference between orientation and induction? Anyone who are on the program can answer this. What is the difference between orientation and induction? Are they both the same?
No, sir.
Dear learned colleagues who are on program, can you answer or can you talk about what is orientation program and are the same? Or
the orientation is for faculty and induction is for students, sir.
Okay. I'll give you 50% here. Fine. It goes like this, ma'am. It's not only for students.
Yes, sir.
It's not only for students. It's not only for faculty. Orientation is for orienting the students, welcoming them to the portals of your college. You're from which institute, ma'am?
Sir, I'm from J.S.S. Noida, sir.
J.S.S. Noida, okay, good.
Noida.
Good. Okay, very good, very good. Orientation program is for orienting the students and parents for the particular education. So let us look at Noida now. First day of the college, you have invited parents and students for your program, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. That time, parents may be a doctor, parents may be a farmer, parent may be a businessman. What you are going to talk to them in orientation program? You are going to orient them, telling them, first is you are welcoming them to your portals of JSS Noida.
Yes, sir. Yes,
you will talk about university. You will talk about UP Technological University. Then you will also look at the parents. Parent may be a doctor or, as I said, a businessman. He may not be knowing what is engineering education. You are going to tell them there are 8 semesters, there are going to be like this, this assignment is like this, and you have a semester system like this, you are going to orient them.
Yes, sir.
So it means, in nutshell, orienting parents, students after welcoming to the portals of JSS Mysore, JSS Noida. Okay, that is orientation. Then what is induction? You are inducting them to the program, maybe mechanical engineering, maybe electronic engineering, maybe civil engineering. Then you will also talk about what kind of document need to be captured here. That is more important here. The day one orientation program, you need to capture certain data. What is the data? How many parents attended? How many students attended? All the data need to be shown while the peer committee visits your college. In case of induction, you're going to tell the students how my program, I think everybody is aware of what is program. Those who are going for MBA, they're aware of it.
Yes,
program means mechanical engineering is a program. Civil engineering is a program. Okay. Bachelor of Arts is a program. In arts, it could be HEPS. So they're called as programs. course means a particular subject is called course. Kindly all my dear learned colleagues, kindly learn things like what is program, what is course. These are all very key issues in new education policy. Okay, in induction you are going to talk about how I do conduct my practicals, what kind of uniform you need to do, what kind of discipline you need to be there, what kind of assignments you are going to give them. All this is called as induction program. Maybe half a day you are going to orient them. In half a day you are going to induct them to the portals of our departmental portal. And then you will talk about your discipline, you will talk about hostel things, you will talk about your library, how many books you are going to get, when the books to be given back. All that kind of things will come in induction program. And that day, some colleges have got first year uniform. They're going to give uniform. They're going to talk about what is the methodology to wear uniform, all that. Then program for freshers. AACT has clearly brought out few programs like PDP, personality development program, a skill-based program, or soft skill program. This need to be very, very nicely learned here. Next is, what is remedial classes? Other colleagues can log on and they can answer. What is remedial classes? Any idea? What is remedial? Hello? So people or teachers on the program. Yeah, what is remedial classes?
For slow learners.
Yes, slow learners. How do you identify slow learners?
They are not able, suppose I have explained something to them, they have not been able to catch. So I observe them in the class. Okay. Also during their exams or tests, they are not scoring that good marks.
Correct.
So I will give them that remedial classes and try to bring them up to the standard.
Fantastic. The answer is perfectly answered. You deserve Thank clapping. You deserve clapping, but we can't do that now. Okay. So look at here how it works. You're right. You deserve clapping. Thing is, after you administer the first test, let us say first test you administered. Hello, are you with me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You administered first test after, say, about 6 weeks of learning.
Yes, sir.
You have taken class average. Suppose one has scored 25 out of 25, one has scored 0, one has scored 10, like that. We have done an average. Average is 15.
Yes, sir.
Okay. There are 10 students in the class who have scored less than 10.
Yes.
So then you are considering them as slow learner.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
After identifying the slow learner, see, this is the methodology document need to be captured here.
Yes.
You need to have a proper document of first test. After having the test, you need to show it on the notice board. Then you identified them. After doing remedial, you need to conduct extra classes for them, right?
Yes, I have conducted.
While conducting classes, where is your timetable accommodation? At the end of the day, you need to show that remedial classes for slow learner.
Yes.
Then you need to take attendance for the slow learner.
Yes, definitely.
After having done for a week or so, then you need to administer one more test, whether they learnt or not.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then if they are good, then they are going to be with the mainstream.
Yes,
so
sir.
One remedial issue means these many things will come into picture.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is BIT scores? BIT scores.
Sir, especially for those lateral entry students, those who are not familiar with the language. And there are some subjects. For them, we will conduct some classes. That is bridge course.
Which branch, madam? JSS, which branch?
Mechanical, sir.
Mechanical. Fine. In case of, let us take it very conveniently, understanding others. So, for example, let us talk about, I'm a computer science student. Yes, now, sir. Vacation started. But now next course I am going to learn on, let us say, C++. I have no basic knowledge on C++. So therefore, during 15 days time or 20 days time, I am going to give a bridge course on C++. Therefore, when the class starts, there could be 12th standard students from CBSE pattern. There could be 12th standard students from the state board. In case of those who are only opting for engineering, they have already studied C++, they are in the 12th standard.
Yes.
In case of some certain board, they don't have that knowledge. Therefore, we conduct some bridge courses. For first year, what you can do normally JSS is, at NOIDA is, when you first day when the student come, you can give administer a forum, their competency levels in languages and other things. Those who come from bit rural, those who come from Delhi, you don't have to worry about them, NOIDA, Delhi.
Sir.
Area. Where they come from, local, I mean, little rural area, their first day is problem is language. They may not have competency in English. You can administer some bridge course on English. First day could be in English. In case of management, I'm talking about MBA. There are some students who join the course for MBA. MBA attracts all branches. It could be Bachelor of Arts, Commerce, Math, Science, Engineering, Medicine, Dental, all that. Because I have the students who passed out in dental. They have done dental degree, then they came to me as students. They, suppose first day when I take a class on accountancy, accounting for managers, there is a subject, there is a course. They will not know anything about the accounting for managers because they don't know what is debit, what is credit, what is accounting cycle, like that. So what we do is 1 week bridge course we do for them. So therefore, when I start my course, everybody is at equal in the class. Okay. Next is do your I know UP board may be having the scholarship, right? Scholarship program for married students, for girls studying, for rural, all that. Karnataka government has got all this in place. And only thing is, what is your role then as an institute is you need to properly publish on their websites, properly publish on notice boards, and encourage deserving students for scholarship. There is a duty. So for that, there has to be a documentation. Next is free ships. Do you have any free ships? Suppose I scored 100 out of 100 in all my subjects in 12th standard. Are you giving me some free ships?
Yes, sir. There is a fee waiver quota.
Sorry?
Fee waiver quota is there, sir. Fee waiver, as per the government. Yes, sir.
Fee waiver quota. Correct. This is what you do. You are going to be edged over the other institutions. Therefore, intelligent students join your course. Free ships. Encourage them by giving free ships. Next is innovation. And I was working earlier with PESET, PES, Bangalore. Now it is university. Those who score more than 80% in Kannada medium, they will have free education. They will have free education to encourage rural colleges and students from rural area.
Okay.
And I have seen PES. Tell me.
No. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay, innovation and creativity in teaching. It is an art, it is basically, right? It involves art, it involves drama, it involves lot of things. A teacher is multiple of many things. How can you do innovation and creativity in teaching is a key issue. You must make your notes or your teaching pedagogy should be so innovative and creative so that they always hook to that. These are the key challenges here. And during COVID system, I think many of my colleagues must have logged on to various other universities and they must have fine-tuned their lecture notes. My student is there, was a student 20 years back. Whenever he met, still I remember, sir, what you taught 20 years back. I don't know what I taught 20 years back. I can teach much better today. But still she remembers the 20 years back what I taught. And she says that how I used my blackboard. Total blackboard, that time blackboard it was. Blackboard, then, you know, all that she remembers. She's with me now. I'm VTU, I'm attending classes for them. There's one software, but it is not taking place. Okay. Next is teacher quality. Kindly attract as many as possible teachers with higher qualification like PhD, then lot of paper publication, lot of research, all that kind of issue here. Teacher quality. That day when the peer team visits you or when you fill up the chart, teacher quality is more important. Next is UGC government norms. Never ever, I repeat, never ever violate the rules of the government while recruitment. This is one of the key issue here. Okay, recruitment and promotion and PhD, all those issues will come in teacher quality. How many papers they published, how many books they have written, how many seminars they conducted. Conducted, attended, both will come here. The teacher need to be very, very updated here. 50 marks are there for teacher. So therefore, how to get better marks is by having a better teacher. Latest technologies are used by the faculty for effective teaching. I think most of them are using, for example, your mechanical engineering section, how many cross-sectional things are there with you, how much of PPTs you are using. For civil engineering, I know, if you log on to National Geography, you get lot on engineering marvelance. So therefore, can you bring it to class and show them? Well, suppose there is a subject on survey, a subject on bridges, a subject on let us some other subject. When they can show to the students, so that students could be aware of things, what is happening. Reforms, transparency, I think most of this has come now. Transparency has come because you know, admission is online, payments are online. They're to the extent, Digital India is working here. Most of the institutions are at par on this. Only thing is, there's one more thing coming up is called EDI, Electronic Data Interchangeability. Can entire students of JSS Noida can be seen in some university in USA? Can suppose now I give my university number in case of in Karnataka, VTU gives a unique number called some BD-CS like that. You put that number, you can see everywhere. Can university in USA do that? Can the data can be interchanged so that our authenticity can be checked? Now we submit hard copy and all that, you know, transcripts we call them. That will go off. That should go off in any way. So that you know, things will fall in place with the universe. Next, admission policy. Do you have clarity in admission policy? This has also come very nice because in case of CET, in case of NEET, recently concluded, if you look at NEET for PG programs, very, very neat it is now. Across the country, they conducted one test. Then if you are selected, automatically the challan will come to you. Then you can fill the fee, required fee, and automatically admission letter will come to you. All sitting in one place on the palm top, you can do everything now. This really I experienced with this admission policy now. Because COVID has brought many things, let us say, they made a lot of good things. COVID has brought a lot of good things here. Okay, follow government norms, student enrollment and profile. Kindly see that Mr. Modi, Prime Minister of our country, talks about inclusive growth. What is that inclusive growth? Inclusive growth could be in terms of looking at these lower strata people who are, for various reasons, they could not come up. But do you have commitment to bring up to your level? It could be SC, it could be ST, it could be other backward community. All these need to be represented properly. When I say country is rich, rich in manpower, everybody should be equal at it. Everybody should be given equal opportunity to come up. Those who are not have that opportunity, please, you have to see that documentation has to be there for that. The key issue here is how many SC you are given, how many ST you are given, how many OBC you are given. Now things are very clear because government itself decides on this. Okay, next is demand ratio. Have you guys anytime calculated demand ratio? Is there a demand for your course? Demand for your program? You need to do this. Demand. Those who are in lockdown, please see that there is a demand or not. Simply, if I open 20 programs and there are no demand for that, there has to be demand. You have to demand. How many students applied for your program? Suppose Noida JSS has got 120 seats. You have 240 students. It means demand is too high. Okay, like that it is. Then IT integration is one area. I think most of the institutions have got IT integration now. They are doing it. Still, they are doing it. And grievance. How best you redress grievances are addressed. Redressal mechanism is very, very important in academics. Someone has come up, say it could be examination redressal mechanism. Someone is caught while copying. How quickly you are redressed? Whatever the punishment, that is later on. Did you ask immediately? And you know, due to this technology, even copying method is also changed a lot now. There are too many, too high tech it is now. But do we have the proper committee? If the committee is there, when did the last meet? How many cases have been registered? What was the final outcome? You cannot keep holding, too long. It should be immediately done. Suppose you want that one student to be debarred or you have to send him out of the institute, you have to be telling him in advance, quickly. Suppose one particular semester is not eligible, you should tell him quickly. That is how it is, redressal mechanism. And continuous internal assessment. I leave it to the program concern. Some program they can have snap test, they can have on-the-spot assessment, or they can have one or two questions in the class. So the teacher, before he's starting his delivery mechanism, he can ask one or two questions. That could also be an internal mechanism. But only thing is, see that proper record is maintained here. No student should be having any grades that I am not properly assessed. Assessment going to be very, very key issue here. Next is examination management system. I think software. I am in VTU premises today. VTU is one of the leading technological university in the state and I think in the country. I am proud to say that. they have done a lot. I think about 15 years back itself, they have done this system. Entire management, they do answer sheets on. You can do evaluation sitting at your own place. And, you know, in other universities I have seen in US, where a teacher is very competent, who taught the course, he can use the, you know, he can do the assessment and submit it in a day or two. That is the level there. Adhere to academic calendar. On first place, do we have proper academic calendar? I think almost all the institutions have got this now. Okay. I think VTO has got very neat and clear calendar, but question year does not end. Calendar gives only 2-3 key issues, but in the institutions or the program chair, co-chair has to do a lot of things. University may give opening date, closing date, examination date, but remaining everything has to be done by the program coordinator. What it should be, when should be the first test, when should be the second test, when should be the sports, when should be the celebrations. And you need to see that totally, suppose if there are 56 hours, in case of VTU, some subjects are 56 hours. Do I really encash on 56 hours? Because you know, we are not supposed to miss even an hour. That is a loss for our students. So therefore, how I am going to do this calendar of event is going to be the key issue. I think many institutes have done a wonderful job in designing and developing this calendar now. I have seen when is the sports, when is the founder day, when is national days, when are the holidays. You are going to give it well in advance so that students, parents can plan proper things. When is going to conduct alumni day, when is the book review day, a lot of things like that. Okay. So yeah, a calendar of events. If there are any coordinators for criteria 2, please note all this. In out of 550, there could be in charge for criteria 2. They need to do this. They need to have a proper calendar of events. One which is given by, suppose if it is an affiliating college or affiliated college, where you, the university will give you 2 or 3 important dates, that is opening date, closing date, examination date. Remaining everything, the college has to do that. Because this attracts marks here. Next is timetable. How best you have designed your timetable? Usually, there has to be link between the subject taught previous to this and the next subject. Suppose you put some different subject, it won't go good. Students should have continuous learnability. Because there has to be a link between the subjects. This is a very, very key issue. Timetable designing is, and as a, for a teacher, timetable is nothing but God. It's like God, you have accepted the teaching job, you are like, it's a God's job it is. Therefore, you never ever miss one class even. So timetable is very critical. Designing timetable, putting proper subjects is a different skill set altogether. Next is syllabus copy. A library anyway have to have the syllabus copy, and teacher must have syllabus copy. And the HODs or coordinators of the department is the responsibility to give them or supply them latest syllabus copy. If possible, it has to be stamped properly by the department. Therefore, they don't teach old syllabus. Next is teaching plans. How best you design your teaching plans? My submission to all my learned colleagues is during the vacation, the subject is allotted before the vacation. Therefore, draw as many books as possible from library, go through each syllabus topics, break down into number of hours. Please tell the students which page, what topic is available. I can share some of my teaching plans. Therefore, you can tell the students clearly that what they should read and come to the next class. That's called pre-assigned reading. Therefore, you can deliver class in a much, much better way. I think people are on that program can appreciate this. I just go through this. This itself is a big topic. This is a Bloom taxonomy. These are the stages: remembering, understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, creating. Because class composition is all walks of life. Somebody may be very brilliant. Somebody may be a slow learner. To see that, how do you take care of all of them? Sometimes as a teacher, I'm teacher for the last 20 years. Some students make noise in the class. There is a standard complaint. If he is so brilliant, can you make him to do something better in the class? Can you take care of others? A lot of issues. Just I will touch this. This is a topic just different altogether. in case of remembering, what they should remember? Exhibit memory of previous learned material by recalling facts, terms, basic concepts and answers. So in the class when you enter, just ask the definition, ask some of the key issues, ask some of the formulas, whether they really remember or not. They have to remember only. Example, choose, define, these are all called active verbs. There, I'll show you the active verbs. There are plenty, it's all available on the web. Those who are interested, they can log on and get all this. There are plenty of active verbs available. So you must make your students learn in the class. You don't only teach and come. See that how much they learned. In case of understanding, demonstrate understanding of facts and ideas by organizing, comparing, translating, interpreting, giving descriptions and stating main ideas. Example, classify, compare, like that it is. Some of the key verbs I have put here, creative verbs. Solve problems to new solutions by applying acquired knowledge. Now you have enough knowledge. Can you use that knowledge? And then can you do something else? There may be facts, there may be techniques, there may be rules in a different way. Apply, build models, we say. We teach one or two, then we ask the students to go and go ahead to do this. Why don't you apply here? You must practice all this in the class actually. Suppose your very basic example, A plus B whole square formula. How to apply this? Where is applied? Suppose civil engineering, you have a formula, where to apply? For construction of bridge, what kind of formula to be applied? There are some people are asking, why should you learn mathematics now? Basic question. But there are issues like this. Next, in analyzing, examine and break information into parts, identifying motives or causes. Make inferences. You have to do, those who have done PhD, you know what is the meaning of inferences. You have to do always at the end of the lecture, you should have an inference. And find evidence to support generalization. In this case, analyze. Assume. We also sometimes say assume. In case of our some of the problematic issues, we say assume. Come in case study, while in MBA program we do case studies, we sometimes say missing data. You have to assume. When you say assume, you should have a previous knowledge. Next, evaluating. Present and defend opinions by making judgments about information, validity of ideas, quality of work based on set of criteria. Agree, disagree, appraise. You have to suppose if I given a statement, if I given a case study, then I may ask him, come, why don't you evaluate? A particular decision taken by an individual or a protagonist in the case, is it okay or not okay? So like that issues it is. Creating. Compare information together in a different way by combining elements in a new pattern or proposing alternative solutions. Adapt, construct. Just so in a simple example, passing remark, I can talk about Bangalore, raining, flood. See, this is all in bits and pieces. If I say properly put it, if I can construct properly, there is heavy rains in Bangalore, which is causing floods and traffic is disturbed. I constructed it. There could be every subject that could be like this. These are action verbs or active verbs, we say. There are plenty of them available in the web. Please log on to web and then get it. Coming to the third one, research, innovation and extension. Look at this course here, university. Please, you know, those who are working in university, they must notice here it is 250 marks. In case of autonomous, it is only 150. In case of affiliated college, it is only 120. Because this is 3.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They are called key indicators, key aspects and key indicators. Here, your indicator is minused. Here, one indicator is minused for affiliated colleges. You can go back and see there are two less in that. Okay. Promotion of research and facilities, 20. Now you must know what are the labs available, where are they available, what are things available, instruments available, all that. Resource mobilization, where do you get money? Innovation and ecosystem. Do your university has got ecosystem built? Suppose I need some spectroscopy or something that is available, system is available. Can I work after the working hours? Research publication and awards is more important. 100 marks. University, please, university members, please look at this. 100 marks weightage here. Next is consultancy. University can have consultancy. because people may contact university because it is higher learning institute. Look at the affiliated colleges, they removed this because there is no much consultancy in accredited affiliated colleges. Extension activities 40 and collaborations 20, because university can do a lot of collaborations. What are the key components? Is your institute research center recognized? First plus place, affiliated colleges and autonomous institutions, research center. Do you have research center? If research center is there, as per that committee, you have all the requirements available. What could be those things? Research committee. Do you have a research committee in your department, in your program? Next, provisions for research facilities. Suppose they say that you need a certain lab, a certain books, certain systems. Do you have that? Do you have laboratory equipment? Now the key component come here is you must write proposal so that you can get funds from UGC, get funds from NAC, get from departments, Department of Biotechnology, Department of Science and Technology. There are a lot many organizations. Here it matters a lot. It means your teachers have the ability to write proposals and get money, get fund. Then research journals, do your institute has research journals? Are you bringing out research journals? If the journal you are bringing out, is it a quality journal? Is it ISBN number? Is it peer reviewed? Is it double blind? Is it single blind? There many things here. When I talk about journal, journal itself has got there are many points here. Next is, it missed in this in between it was missed. Now it is okay. Available? Okay. So now I was talking about journals. Is your department is bringing out journal? What kind of journal? Research journal. If people are submitting papers to you, what is the blind review or peer review? All that will come here. Next is, do you have MOUs with higher learning institutions? Suppose if you have affiliated college, you have the with other institutions. Do you have collaborations? It could be industry collaboration. It could be other higher learning academic institutions. There are many affiliated colleges where I have seen they have collaborations with IITs, IIMs, or some of them are with the boards like DRDO, HAL, or some good companies like GE, General Electric. They have lot petrol-based companies. They have got lot many companies have got tied up with GE. Like that it is okay. Collaboration with research centers. There are many research centers even in private institutions also now. So you can also log on to them. Reputed centers and research initiatives. What are the research initiatives that the institute you have taken? Output in terms of how many number of PhD you have produced from this program. How many students are enrolled? Kindly log on to UGC's latest new rules and regulation. One teacher can have maximum number of eight students. Please see that you take care of 6 general, 2 reserved. Don't violate the norms. And while the peer team visit, they check for this. Then research articles. Have you published research articles? Have you published books? Published? What is impact factor? All that kind of thing. How many of you are Google Scholar? I think most of you are Google Scholar, right? Enroll yourself as a Google Scholar, because now the assessment can also be done through distance mode. So therefore, if you say that I am a Google Scholar, why don't you log on and see? They can see very well wherever they are. Books published, how many books you published? Extension activities, what all the extension activities you have started with? Do you have NSS? Do you have NCC? Do you conduct donation camps? Do you do green issues? Do you take some issues like cleaning rivers? Or are you going to empower, teach or learn or involved with empowering neighborhood? Are you going to primary schools and teaching something? There are 100. And you can also log on here is UN initiatives. If you go to UN initiatives, they have got proper guidelines here. You can take any one of them or many of them, depend upon the strength of the institute. Awards and recognitions, budget for supporting student research projects. This is very clear here. When it comes to 5, I will also go in depth, but now proper budgeting mechanism has to be there. Every institution now they are tuning up. You must have available on your desktop or your hard copy with you. What is the budget earmarked for me? How much I need to spend? What was the last year? Because 5 years data you need to fill up. So therefore you need to have at least 5 balance sheet with you. 5 department, whatever exactly budget system should be available with you. And how much you have spent and how much is deficit or how much you did not spend it. There could be a lot of issues. See, now for those faculty who are, I mean MBA faculty here, not many projects are coming up for COVID system. They are asking data on health issues. So they can involve student and teacher, and they can all the state governments have this program now. Next, what all the collaborations you have? You can also collaborate with for conducting workshops, seminars, conferences. You don't have to do alone. Then if you talk about conferences, is it a national, international, all that will come into picture here. How many national, how many international? Okay, we're conducting national, how many international, how many international persons to be present here in the conferences, all that kind of issue. Do you conduct training programs? If you have conducted, how many people attended, what is the methodology, all that. Then projects sponsored by industry. Do you have an industry project sponsored? Suppose mechanical civil engineering in many colleges have got industry sponsored, like water testing, soil testing, then cement block, concrete, stencil strength checking. Also, so many projects are there. So please be in touch with the DCs of various districts. They have a lot of projects. They give it to institutes now. The soil, so those are from civil engineering. You have a soil mechanic lab where you can do all those things without spending much, but whereas you get a credit. Then the industry interaction, do you take your student to industry? If so is the case, when was the last, how many students gone, where is the permission for that? Because it's a documentation. Simply I cannot say that I have gone to industry. Well, if you do, how did you do? Suppose if you call an industry person to your college, what was his qualification? Where did it come? When did he come? It takes some few photographs and then build record here, because you need to upload in SSR. Then there are various funding agencies. Have they funded for industry visits and all that? Ecosystem created by innovations, incubation centers. I think many colleges have already started with incubation centers. And the Atal Incubation Center, one, lot of funding is available in that. I think people can make use of that particular funding agency. UACT has got a lot of funding programs. You can take, because you need to be first eligible is that, you need to be NBA accredited, you need to be NAC accredited, all that kind of thing. Extension activities could be NSS, NCC, blood bank, survey, social surveys, adapting villages. I mentioned only few here. If you log on to UN website, you get lot many things like this. Can you make your neighborhood happy? All our education, all our students is to make people happy. Can you make your student involved in this? That is a key issue here. You can learn a lot by being outside. The old traditional method of learning has gone now. Coming to infrastructure, it is 100 marks. Almost everybody is same here. Physical infrastructure, as per your respective council, do you have classrooms? Do you have required seminar halls? Do you have required labs? That is more important. But one AICT is very liberalized now is you can have multiple programs put together, share resources. So therefore, you should take benefit of this. Earlier, there has to be a separate engineering college, polytechnic college like that. Now we can club them, we can use them, make different shifts, lot of things, because you cannot make system idle. Therefore, you need to use them properly. You need to calculate every building, every classroom, how much it is used, usage pattern. Okay. Library is a learning resource, that is 20 marks. IT infrastructure 30, maintenance of campus infrastructure 20. So therefore you need to have proper documents for this. Look at what are those facilities for teaching, learning, infrastructure facility, classroom, seminar, etc. I think most of the institute has got this. Now, however, now AICT, those who are engineering colleges, relaxed a lot now. But however, you should have proper things. So usually the earlier classroom size was 60 square meters. It means 1 square meter per student. Now the 10% plus or minus, that is 66 square meter you should have. So that a student who are lateral entry, others will come and join, or those who are detained, they may also come and join. So it means one classroom should be 66 square meters. So think about it, and also log on always. I may say something, but you must always log on to your respective councils. Each council, they have brought something different. Okay. Medical, it is totally different. Seminar hall. Now I think one seminar hall is shared between two departments now. Please make use of all these benefits. Next, library advisory committee. If you have library, do you have an advisory committee? There are three types of library basically. One is central library, second is departmental library, third is an individual teacher can have his own library. In case of central library, you need to have rare collection of books. Other than the, suppose the engineering college, why not you have books on law? Why not you have books on philanthropy? Why not you have books on history? How good is your library? That's called rare books, we call them. Then do you have earmarked budget? You need to have proper budget. For that, again, you log on to your various councils. Library is a learning resource. See, earlier, library was known as only dumping books. Now, librarian qualification to become a librarian is PhD. It means he is with us. He is called as a professor now. Therefore, he has to oppress, he has to tell the faculty members, he has to have an entire database of the college, he need to pump them, he need to do a lot of work now. The learning resource, now it is entirely changed. The role of librarian has got changed here. Therefore, you need to take librarian along with you. Those institutes which are going for NAT, please don't leave them. Please keep them with you so that they are going to get you good marks here. Next is library hours. AICT is clearly mentioned how many you have to put up clearly on the notice board of the library that how many hours your library is going to work. It has to be proper. There are hours mentioned there. Adequate number of books, journals. Now it could be e-journal. There are a lot of changes have come in. Please be with your respective councils. Then library, digital library. I think now it is most of it is digital. So is really that much capability is there for your system or not? You're talking about digital library, but your systems are old, not able to access, you're not subscribed for some of them, then you need to do this. How many softwares are available? Are you the member of InfluNet, Information Library Network in the country under a UGC body, that is? Are you a member of that? Not many things you need to do here. Don't simply tell that digital library and keep two systems. Make system really useful, attract students to the library. Now, everybody says information available, they don't want to come. But however, it is a teacher who gives the best assignment, who gives the challenging assignment to students, who go back to the library, search for good books or journals, then they make their assignment. The good students are one who do all this. And you must give a lot of assignments to students, make a lot of contact hours, a direct contact hours less. Therefore, they spend useful time or productive time on doing all these assignments or things. The old method was classroom teaching, maximum classroom teaching. Now that has gone. Make other system available so that there is useful. Make them independent, make them learnable, make them, you know, industry ready, make them competitive in the market. Equip them with lot of skills. That is more important here. Automation of library is another key factor. Do your library automated? Is students book issue received searching? Then you know I have seen a library in Harvard where there is no librarian at all. That nobody is watching what you do. Everything is, you know, you have to do yourself there, including taking books. 24 hours open library at Harvard. I'm talking about US Harvard is 24 hours open. Anybody can go and read anytime. It's all recorded, all cameras, everything. Absolutely. No intervention, no interference from anybody. Collection of rare books, already I mentioned. So look at library. These many, if you want good marks for your library or your college or better grade, you need to do all this. Next, do you have the manuscripts? There are a lot of manuscripts available. Then updated IT facilities, including Wi-Fi, LAN, software. Procedure for maintenance. Next is, do you have proper procedure for maintenance of your infrastructure? That's a key issue. Government institutions can build one time and give you, but have you maintained? It starts from maintaining from where? Maintaining of your DG sets, how to calculate how much your power you need. There are some state where there is still deficit in power. They have what you call as DG set. DG means diesel generator sets. How to calculate how much DG set, what capacity DG set I need? You need to calculate total consumption, including light, lift, lab, everything. Then you need to have at least 40% of the captive energy in the form of DG set. Why you need that? Not for fan or AC. At least students should not miss their labs, because lab is a learning activity. Say in case of engineering, you may have between 12 to 14 or maximum 16 labs, because 16 weeks is a program or a semester. If they miss about 4 or 5 of them, then it is a loss for them. So therefore, nobody should miss even one lab. They must do lab, because there is a lab where they learn partial skills in that maintenance, physical utilization of all those, academic support, etc. Additional facilities for sports. See, now here is, when you say that we are importing knowledge, and at the end of the day, I am bringing out student, means all around development of a student has to be considered here. A student who join your institution must have knowledge, must have skills, must have ability to adapt to the new system. How do you impart skill here? One is through syllabus, a structured syllabus. Second is through assignments, practicals. Then comes labs. Then comes, it is through at the end of the semester, they have to submit the reports. That could be called as project report or thesis or whatever it is, different language. Different university use different terminology, so that you are going to impart skills to the student that is capable of reading, capable of writing, and capable of presenting in those forms. Next is, you should have right attitude for the job. Suppose I have chosen to become an example. I have chosen to become a computer science engineer. Computer science engineer demands a lot many hours work in front of system. Now in the COVID system, we can know that many people are locked down at least for 10 hours, 12 hours. If I don't have that ability to learn new things and be in front of the system, I'm unfit to be a computer science engineer. Suppose I have decided to become a good civil engineer. When I decided to be a good civil engineer, suppose today 24th floor RCC is going on. Do you think if I'm not able to climb 24th floor and unsupervise that, then what is my good use of my civil engineering then? Suppose today I need to take a survey. Let us say today temperature is Delhi, 40 degree temperature, 42 degree temperature. You cannot say that, no sir, I am too tired, I cannot go in the hot sun. How can you be a better civil engineer then? So it means you need to imbibe, you need to build proper ability or proper aptitude for that. So it means you should have knowledge, you should have adaptability. Therefore, you need to have a lot of sports, games, then comes extracurricular activities, all that, and you need to have a health center. And health center is simple nowadays, so many colleges are within the city itself. We can tie up with the other better facility available. So in case of emergency, we can be shifted faster, all that kind of issue. If you have a girls hostel and boys hostel separately, then you should have one health center in girls hostel. It may hear a lot of things in criteria 4. How best is your hostel maintained? What kind of co-curricular after the class hours are over? How your students are equipped? Do they have sports grounds in hostel premises? Do they have TV? Do they have papers? How do they spend their time? We must engage them. There's a word called engage. You must engage students. How do you do that? And what kind of documents you need to keep there? It starts from allotment of room till the time they vacate. All that kind of activities you need to do. Next, health center, a minimum, basic minimum health center thing should be like sudden students. Usually, if you look at hostels, they fall sick, in case of girls hostel, it is a bad patch of 3 or 4 days. What kind of things are available? in case of their disposable mechanism of their health issues, pads. There are machines burning available. Everything is available now. The only thing is how best you are equipped all this. Next comes maintenance of campus. It's very, very important. Do you have you signed MOU with somebody who is doing this? Do you have the work contract or agreement with AMC, annual maintenance contracts, maybe for computer, maybe for building, maybe for any other issues, maybe for DG sets, maybe for laboratory equipments. Look at that. In DG set, I already told you, total energy consumption in your college or your department or your program, at least 40% of that should be in the captive energy, so that you don't miss on labs. DG set is diesel generator set. Coming to the fifth thing, criteria, 30, 40, 20 and 10. See here, student progression. Look at what are things involved here. Do you have student councils in your college? Many, many names are there. Some colleges say student councils. Somebody says various names. So I kept this as a general, student councils, representation of students. Some engineering colleges, do you have AICT chapter, IST chapter? We have IST chapter. We have telecommunication, there is one thing, chapter. Computer science, they have some chapters. Do you have that? Do your students participate in this? Do you encourage postgraduate students, basically, do you encourage them to go and do paper presentation? All that kind of issue. How many students have participated in paper presentation? For internal assessment, you need to calculate all this. Students on academics, administrative bodies, are they member on your, national committee or sports committee? There are many committees, about 15 or 16 of them, they are there. So you use students in those committee, involve them, because they are the stakeholders. Some of the committee, they have the parents in the committee. You must make the parents also a committee. For this, you should have the proper list, communication to them. Then comes the, when did you conduct the last meeting? What are the minutes of the meeting? Then that file is complete. There are about 15 to 16 committees are there here. You need to be very, very clear in this criteria, lot of things here, including SRA. Suppose, do you have anti-ragging committee? Who are the committee members? What were their duties? Are they clear with the duties? Did you identify any cases? Or even if there is no cases, you have to submit a report saying that nil anti-ragging cases this year. Then that committee gets closed. Contribution from alumni association and chapters. Is your alumni association is registered? The simple process it is, you have to register it. Do you involve your students as committee members? There are marks for this. I have seen an institute of a 50 years old institution, they did not have alumni chapter. They lost very badly, lost on lot of marks on this. Please see that you have alumni association registered. Registration and all that, it takes about only half an hour, and money spending is only 500 or 1000 rupees. The institutes will spend and do that. Do we have alumni account? Because we collect fee at the time of admission called as alumni fund. Is that fund is transferred to that account? These are things here. Next is chapters. Suppose if the institute is very old institute, do they have the chapters outside? Bangalore chapter or Mangalore chapter or USA chapter, UK chapter. There are many institutes, they have the chapters because their students are working here and there. Student support and mentoring is very, very critical here. Do you have a mentoring system in place? Is there any difference between mentoring and counseling?
So there is some.
Can you be elaborate, please?
So mentoring is basically kind of guiding, sir. And whatever issues they have, we will have to go through, even to a extent beyond academics also, if not personally.
Correct. Next, counseling.
Counseling is, I think it's more of academics in case if they have any issues connected to counseling.
Okay.
Each faculty member is allotted with some students, so maybe it's in numbers of 8 or 10.
We are supposed to
guide them in all the issues which come in the perspective of the management as well as their academic issues. Okay. We will only have to monitor them in terms of their upgradation in academics, if I'm right, sir.
Fine, good. At least 70% you are right. I would like to elaborate on this. What is the difference between mentoring and counseling? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. What? Who is the best mentor in the world? Any idea? I would like to drag some of the issues of the history. Krishna mentored Arjuna. Chanakya mentored Chandragupta. Okay.
Got it.
Got it. No? So mentoring is an issue. Where, how do you identify whom to be mentored? A top one, a class A, a grade A student need not to be mentored. You need, again, it's a very, very meticulous work of a teacher. In fact, a teacher is one who knows entire pulse of the class. He has to identify students. He has to keep a proper record. Then he has to call them separately. When I do mentoring to X, Y should not be there. There is an issue here. Okay. So therefore, I identify the key issue. Suppose one is A plus plus grade student, you need to go ask him to do something better than that. Look at how Krishna did for Arjuna, or how Chanakya did for Chandragupta. Identifying the key potentials of individual, and then you are with them. I can in US how they do, I can tell you.
Yes.
These two things, okay? I'll share my experience. In case of counseling, hello. Hello.
Yes,
sir. I think you are there. Okay. Can I have your name and institute?
Sir, my name is Ashish from Amrita University in Mysore.
Mysore.
And I'm also working as a research scholar under the guidance of my sir.
Yeah. In case of counseling, it could be done by professional counselors. Hello. It should be done by professional counselors. They could be, qualification could be MA, psychology. Ma'am, please mute. Hello, ma'am, who is on the program? Please mute. Your conversation being heard here. Please mute if you want to do other conversation. Okay. Mentor, counseling should be done by professional counselors. They could be, qualification could be MA psychology, MA industrial psychology. And what is that, how it goes? There should be a proper room for counseling, and a counselor may not come day to day basis. They may come on a particular case basis. You may have to go and register your case. Suppose in US, what we do, I can talk about it, is students come from different countries. They travel about, say, few thousands of kilometers. So when they are away from their home, that may be first time. They may be feeling homesickness. They may be feeling some issues with the language. They may be feeling issues with temperature. They may be feeling issues with the conditions, cultural issues. Okay, that time you need to call them, counsel them, and you need to be like a parental issues. So very clear distinction between the mentoring and counseling is there, okay? But you need to establish documents for NAC. Sir, okay, Amrita.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Got it, sir.
Guidance, self for students, welfare measures. There are student welfare measures. Every institute should provide safe drinking water. They may not say that give AquaGuard water, but safe drinking water. Then lifts will come in picture here. Handicapped, how they're taken care. Then clean learning environment, all that. Okay. And if there anybody has got any learning difficulties, suppose you have students from Korea, students from some other country where language could be one of the issues. So take them into account to teach them in basic English, give them bridge course, then make them learning. Next comes is placement details. A good institute will have a nice or a great placement cell. And it is led by a placement officer or a faculty in charge for this. He should have enough data. Last 5 years, how many students have participated, how many have got it, how many are working now, all this data. Those officers, those faculty member who in charge of the placement, please see that the eligibility list is to be prepared first. It is your duty. You need to be constantly in touch with companies or recruiters. I told you there are two types of customers, internal, external. Company, our external customer could be companies, government, and NGOs, all these are the external customers. You need to be in touch with them in final year, because now other bodies are telling students they'll miss the classes. That's why you should final year, you should send out a letters to them saying that these many students are eligible. These many students have 90% and above, 60% and above. Sometimes company will specify what kind of students they need. Because if you look at Infosys, if you look at TCS, if you look at all these big guns, they send early. They're saying that these are the skill set you are looking for. The eligible candidate only, you should send them. Kindly see that others are doing. But in case of SSR fulfillment, you need to have proper data for that for 5 years. I'll tell you the formula afterwards. Concern for students. How many students are in touch with you? In the institute, basically. How many of them gone for higher studies? Those who have done B or something, where are they? Masters they are doing in the same institute or other institutes. Suppose you have done the masters in your institute. Have they gone for any PhDs? Or some, suppose one is done PhD, has he gone, taken up any other studies? You need to be in touch with that. I know one institute while doing NBA, they had about 30% of the students who they tracked them basically, and they got good grade in NAC and as well as NBA. Employment, growth in the company is very, very, very important. Suppose 20 years back, you have a student, now he is a general manager of a company or a director of a company. That brings credit to your institution because he has grown so much. Can you track few of them? Because that day when the committee comes here, peer review committee, there is alumni meeting too. Therefore, you need to identify some good alumni who are grown very, very high position. Call them. You have to have a record of that basically. Participation of students in co-curricular and extracurricular activities. How many of your students have participated in, let's say, Olympic games or national games? So that kind of issue, or state level games. You should have the proper record. When did they go? When did they come? Certificate, participation. If they have won some medals and other things, they are at least few pictures should be available in the department. The department coordinator has to keep all these documents, because that day you cannot call them, where are the documents? You should keep on focusing in keeping the documents. To student progression and result analysis. I know in case of VTU, they are very, very, most of the institutions, they have started this. Result analysis, this only one word will open the Pandora box. When the sooner the university declares the result, that individual teacher also should know what is the percentage of my student passed in my subject. That's one kind of analysis. Second is institute. Is my institute, and compared to my competitor, where do I do that? Some universities have got the software already. They themselves will publish this result analysis, so that it will give me an insight to my teaching. How should I teach? When I come to the course file preparation, I will touch upon this. So therefore, your result analysis has to be very, very objective oriented, and you must see that your students are progressed. In new education policy, no student, if a join an institution, can be deprived of his education. He has to progress or he has to exit. 5+3+3+4 has got that system here. Please log on to new education policy, you'll get all this there. Next comes governance. You have, these are the key indicators. There are 5 indicators in this. So 100 marks for this. What are those things you need to do? You need to do is governance and leadership of institution. I'm with the university's faculty members here. Is VTU vision is very clear, all of you? Is it clear? Yes. You're all very clear. Okay. Is this vision is there for your department here? Where is available? When did you last see? When did you last log on to your website? How many of you can work, tell me immediately what is the vision of your department? Okay. Anyway, don't worry. It's a learning. I learned yesterday. You're learning today. That's it. Okay. So organizational structure, you have to have a proper structure. You have to have a proper vision. What is VTU vision? What is VTU regional vision? What is the department of your vision? And goals. You have to analyze each one of them, and then you have to number them. Suppose you have said, we'll conduct 2 international conference and 4 national conference. Have you done this? If not, what was the problem? This time you have planned to produce, who's the criteria for 6? They have to take care of this. This is because they have to coordinate with a lot of other agencies. Suppose you decided this year 5 PhD to be produced from my department. Have you done it? If not, what are the issues? If you decided that at least 5 rank we should get this year, are the students trained for that level? you have to numerically, you have to only verbally, you cannot tell all this. You have to have numerical goals. So therefore, you can achieve it in a much, much better manner. Suppose you said that this year we are going to bring a research journal with ISBN number. Have you done this? Or this year we decided to file at least 2 patents. Have you done this? It will also give you, this one statement is all your marks here. I put it in a very small way so that I can talk about it. This is very, very critical. Everyone must know from top to bottom, from VC to the, because that day VC will present this. I think Manjunath sir is right timely is joined here. Correct time you are joined. Because that day in front of the committee, VC will present. And his vision, his PTs, you have to share and then you have to collaborate with that. If he has say that 100 acres land I have got, then if you say that you have only 2 acres of land, it will be difficult. He said that I have 200 faculty members with PhD, then if you say 198, then it's a problem. So therefore, the vision has to flow from top man to last man in the association over here. Mission, all the boards have to be in place, sir, now. Vision, mission, boards, goals, all the department have to have a clear demarcation in this. And all by and large now, everybody should know at least key words in that. If not entire thing, at least few, because you only designed this. When did you last review this one? When did you last review? Last year. Review meetings are available with you? Who are participated? Some few photographs of the participation? All that is required because vision mission is not written by one person. Because combination of many of you have done that. So that calls for documentation. You have to have proper documentation. Next is perspective and strategic plan of deployment document. How did you do that? Everything, what is the next 5 years, can you tell what you can do? What is next 10 years plan of your department? Do you want to increase the intake from 120 to 240 or to 160, 180, 240? Or you want to have 10 research centers? Or you want to have some innovation center or incubation center? What is your plan actually? Or you need to, you said that you're going to conduct 5 international by 2-3 departments. What is your plan? In next 5 years, how many copyrights you want to have? How many, this is a very big work it is. Welfare schemes, teaching and non-teaching, there are a lot of welfare schemes are available. They ask for PF available, their right time salary, all that kind of thing will come here. Next, is your documentation that is your service book is available? All of you updated? You need to be signed properly by respective people, all that you have to take care here. Then performance appraisal is done. Is every year you have filled up the form, you have filled up your indicators you have filled up. Action is different. But do you have a system in place? If there is a place, where are they? That system, where is your personal file? Actually, department coordinator need to have a personal file of each faculty. It contains latest updated CV, then comes what all the papers published, what all the books written, the front page of the book need to be, Jaraxed and given to them. When the committee comes that day, you have to display all this, because that is only simply verbally. If they tell, they don't accept all that. You need to display. So those are criteria 6. They have to work a bit hard here. The next, program for professional development of staff. Staff means non-teaching staff. Have you conducted any of the program for them? Suppose they know now only Word. Did you do any program for them? So what you can do, computer science department or MBA department can conduct one program for them, one half a day program, maybe on say how to use a PowerPoint, how to use Excel, then record it, how many people have attended. So until your staff is developed properly, your intelligence will not going to be any good for you. They need to be competent here. Your lab technicians, have they really updated? Suppose they are operating on computer system, are they updated with that latest, what is happening? Like that it is. Okay, do you have audits, internal audit and external audits? I think that is taken care. What are required only for your department, that only you should take. Don't take entire finance balance sheet of the university. Because that much time nobody is there and that much space is not there even in system. What is required for your center? What is required for your department? That only if you ask the finance officer, they will give you. Or Manjunath sir, you can contact you, they will give you. Next is, what is the corpus fund status? Do you have any corpus fund? Mobilization of funds, how are you going to get through funds from various agencies? Next is, optimal utilization of resources. I also mentioned other time where, in case of some questions are there repeating here. Are there in infrastructure four criteria? And here morning I was discussing with Professor Manjunath. So optimal utilization of resources, do you have uni programs, do you have certification programs, do you have, are you conducted any MDPs, management development programs? I think a lot of scope here. At least immediately you can start one, because Mysore is doing good with industry. One MDP you can conduct immediately for maybe middle level executives or executives like that. MBA department, you can get marks here. Next, IQAC set up as per the norms. The IQAC talks about internal quality assurance cell. However, it is not mandatory for the cycle one, during cycle one. If it is there one, if it is one you established, you have a better chance. You should establish. If you ask my opinion, you should have one internal quality assurance cell. See, don't find audit means finding fault with somebody. It is not at all finding faults with anybody. It is basically internal looking so that we improve upon the system. Suppose you have done your course for audit I am doing now. Do we have course file? Do we have a timetable? Do we have a lesson plan? Do we have assignment? Do we have lecture notes? Do we have your what you have done this year? When I checking something is missed, you should take it appreciatively, and then you have to put back. Never audit means, in our mind, it is audit means only financial audit and finding fault. Not at all finding fault in academics. It is improving ourselves, improving oneself.
Checks and balances.
Something I may miss out. And in course file, I think you are given the lot of the document report in a course file, few old question papers, then like that. All the things should be proper. And one copy should be available with librarian always. Only librarian is not there, otherwise I would have told him what all the things required here. Okay. So if you can set up as per the requirement, is very good. And let me tell you, if you get a good grade, you'll get money back from NAC here. NAC is going to fund you for maintaining IQAC. You can buy computers, you can buy system, you can buy tables, you can buy projector, all that things. You can get more money because your government setup, you'll get more money. But only thing, you have to do this properly. Coming to the last criteria, this is 100 marks here. Institutional values and social responsibilities, best practices available in the institution. Institution, now it is distinctive. So everybody is working, competitive, a lot of things are there here. Have we done any gender sensitization? Gender sensitization documents are available? Awareness program. Okay. Next, you can call some legal profession for this program. Then you can, you done for faculty? This gender sensitization done for faculty? For faculty it is done? Some yes, some no. Okay, I'll take it. For students also you need to do. What is good touch and bad touch? You have told to the students?
Yes, sir.
Okay, suppose now, night 12 o'clock, today I am working with you. What kind of behavior I should possess now? The IT profession is very, very important here. That need to be told here properly. When I work alone and all ladies working with me, what kind of language I need to use here? So there are issues here. General sensitization is too much, too many things are there here. Sustainability measures now comes to, do we have rainwater harvesting? That is the key, your government, they will ask you first. Do we have green practices, steps taken for environmental consciousness, green audit? What is a green audit? Green audit clearly says how many trees are there for square meters. Suppose there are 1,000 students available, in that means how many trees you need to grow. Anybody from biology, botany department, you can contact them, they will tell you the audit. How many trees should be there? Is there numbered? All the trees should be numbered. All the trees should be named. There are names, so we can put the tag on that. And they will tell you how many trees around the campus, how many trees you should grow, because you need to produce your own oxygen. Why you are taking from other campus? So you need to build this. What steps you have taken here? Green audit. Eco-friendly. All your system are eco-friendly. E-waste. Do you have any provision for collecting e-waste? Very simple. Make one transparent box, keep it at the in the center place, put some initially to put some wires from old phone, everything. Tell every student to put there. Doing e-waste is a big business now. In terms of the 10,000 crore, they talk about this e-business. Because now I think paper, it was there, news, it was there recently, some 2-3 weeks back. Because radium is there, something like that, there was big news. Oh, correct. So therefore, how you collect e-waste? E-waste is a big problem. And how you dispose of, there is a clear cut policy by pollution control board of government of Karnataka. You need to follow this. How are you done your own systems, your old systems, system which is not used? Where did you keep that? Where did you throw that? Are you managing this? You have to show actually. Solid waste management, hostels are there for you, right? How your solid waste management? Are you tied up with municipality Mysore? What have you done? Is there any letter? Suppose hostel food is being sent out from your campus. How are you going to account it for? All these will come here. EE, solid waste management, rainwater harvesting, all the buildings have been connected. Then you can have a water place, all that kind of thing. Human values and professional ethics, which chapter or which syllabus of yours covering these chapters? If you remember, we used to have a subject called in for MBA, Ethical Choices in Business, 1999-2000. Subsequently, that particular subject is removed. I don't know why that is removed. Anyway, so like that, which chapter? Are you giving any extra credit? Are you giving a non-credit course? You are giving them ethics. What all the ethics should be there in our profession? Next, conduct one or two workshops. Little time is there for you. And best practices. What all the best practices your college is doing? Maybe mentoring system you can take, make a book, mentor it, appoint somebody for on call basis. You can show that this is our uniqueness in this Mysore center. Institutional dish, how your institute is distinctive. You are a bit close to IT hub of Mysore. Can you think something here to be distinctive here? Next, innovations carried out in the institutions. Is there any institutions so far they have done? Any papers published or any? For mark, have you filed anything? MOUs, European government university, you can do this much faster. Go to the industry, talk to them, call them, they will be very pleased to work with you. Because great students are supposed to be in the university. So do that. Best practices employed in the institutions, example, best teacher award, anything you're going to give, you get award. In my previous college, there used to be best teacher award. Remember, Rema? Best teacher award, we used to get one silver medal. Five times if you get, six times they are going to give gold medal. So 100% result and all that. I used to get always this. The faculty from maths, they used to always curse me. Because maths 100% getting result is difficult. In case of, but there is a condition, minimum of 25 students should be in that particular course. Because HR course only 10 or 12, 5 you will get 100% result. But minimum condition is 24%. I used to teach TQM. So most of the times everybody passed and I used to get 5 got, I got it actually. Leave trading, some system I have made in leave trading and all that. Anything, you should be distinctive actually. How are you distinctive? Because you can sit together, do one brainstorming session and come out. See, look at is my judgment based on perception, how my mind works. Please tell me what she is doing. Those who are on web also can participate, please. She is jogging, correct? Okay, one says jogging. Somebody says dancing, correct. Next, what else? Think about it. Somebody says dancing, somebody says jogging. Fine, acceptable, accepted, no problem. Now what they're doing? He is changing that. See, now your mind, how your perception has changed, right? Somebody is X is changing Y. Okay, fine, acceptable. Now, both of them are caged by policemen, like correct? Okay, let us look at really what is happening there. If you look at thing here, all of them are running to save this baby who is in trouble. See how your perception got changed over a period of time. When you have seen the girl, you talked about dancing, jogging, all that, men chasing and policemen chasing, but all of them are running towards a cause called saving the baby. So it means, why higher learning, HEI, we use this word higher learning institute is because there are certain exposure we have got, certain high place we have got. There's a duty of you guys, VTU in fact, to drive 212 colleges now. That is my submission to you guys. You got to do a lot here. Okay, some evaluation, 1 o'clock is done, finished. Can I take another 5-10 minutes? Okay, cumulative grading system. Identification of key aspects, already I told you what all the key, what all those issues, what all quantitative, what is qualitative, these are all very important. I worked out one small thing for you, calculation of CG. What is CGPA? No, what is CGPA? Sir, tell me. Yeah.
Sir, cumulative grade point average.
Cumulative grade point, correct. First you have to
calculate. Cumulative grade point.
Cumulative, correct grade. It's a grade point average. GPA means grade point average. And later on, all the seven to be calculated by using formula. This is the formula that can become the CGPA. Those who are in the grading system, they already know what is CGPA. It's so basically standard deviation and Q-ness, all this will come here. What is the grading? What is my intake? What I should do? Well, before leaving the hall, you all should promise, those are on webinar, you should promise, your institution must try for this always. There are eight grading pattern, A double plus A plus A, B double plus B, and C and D. D is not accredited. C and B, again, you require a lot of effort. Only thing you eye for this. I wish all you should eye for this. This grading pattern and all that is available in the web. Please go through. I have spoken enough on this. But once you open, when you become enrolled, then you get all this. Okay. Some documentation where you need to keep is student admission summary, student input quality, student throughput. What is throughput? Suppose 120 students have joined your institute. After 2 years, all the 120 have gone or not? If not, where are they? They failed in one subject, two subject, why did they fail? What are the issues? They did not understand the subject. What is that key issue? A lot of thinking has to go on here. If 120 enrolled to my course or my program, only 90 have gone. Where are 30 people? But we have to figure out, because you have to give. There's a question in case of when you fill up the self-study report, you have to show this. Next is faculty advisor report. You should have a proper faculty advisor. Class committee. Class committees are there. You have to have the class committee. Alumni list, year-wise list is there. So that first you register your alumni association. Student, how many have gone for higher studies? Achievements. Then comes how many are national, international examination they have passed. Like GATE, for engineering, there is a GATE. For MBA, we talk about GMAT. So like that, how many have passed, all that. In case of processes, student list, section-wise. Calendar of events, subject allocation. Subject allocation is very, very important issue. Are you doing the rotation of the subject? Suppose you are taught four times. Till fifth time you are teaching, it means you don't learn new things. Some teachers are the last 20 years, that our teachers, basically. There was no provision like this. They started with the same subject and they ended with the same subject. They did not even change anything. Course information. See, always you should be latest course information. Don't use old one. Laboratory manual, laboratories, if they are the engineering, they have to be very, very careful. Laboratory manual, that day itself, they have to assess and then, if possible, upload. Those who have got the engineering background here, they know about how the lab goes. They keep it on the teacher table and go off. They will sweep, then they will evaluate. That is not the way. If they can do it that day before the season of the work and then tell the student how many 10 marks usually they conduct, and then they can suggest them. What are the mistakes, if any, then they should go for it. Because an engineering student gets about 12 to 14 only for practicals, because our semester is only 16 weeks semester. Even if you miss one, a great loss. Those person who make the timetable, he has to apply a lot of knowledge. Timetable making is not just sitting in one room and in 5 minutes I have thrown that. No. He has to calculate how many national holidays are there, how many things are there. See that day, don't put practical. Suppose something, you look at any timetable, calendar. Monday, some 5 Monday holidays are there. If your practical is on that Monday, what will happen? 5 practical you missed in particular subject. Where is the, what did you learn then? Where is your skill? The person who is timetable officer here? Timetable officer, huh? Timetable officer is a great role. Not that easy. Making timetable is not that easy. Having chosen your profession as teacher, whether you believe it in God or not, your timetable is your God. Not even one class you should miss. That is your should make that effort. Okay. Student mentoring form, individual student file, class conducting file. These are all some document ways you need to have. Timetable, lesson plan, attendance, work diary. Are you maintaining any work diary? Yes. Work diary properly. Anybody checking after that or simply writing something? Who check? When? After program, after semester is over or once in a week? Once in a month. See that everybody says same thing because there's a teamwork. Same question, Kavita, na? I asked you, Kavita, here because I have in BTU, I have gone about 200 committee for LSE. Same question I'll ask that what is her name? Babita. In not in front of you, in some classroom I'll ask her.
Okay, sir.
I'll match them whether they are correct matching or not. Even if you tell correctly, it should be matched. Okay. teacher appraisal, result analysis, leave details. You have proper leave details?
Yes.
Okay, because system is there now. Previous year question papers, list of assignments. Simply cannot say that I give an assignment. You should have the list with you. What assignment you have given, what is the day you have given, what is the day you have closed. How I should do, I'll tell my share experience because 500 people are listening, it's better for them. What I used to do, I used to keep a basket there. Suppose I think KMI remembers that. Suppose I given 5 o'clock on, let us say 14th August, at 5:01, there is to my given called Sanganvara. You used to remove that basket. Anybody brings after that, it goes to straight away to dustbin. Even means peon is deciding your assignment, not me. And he, now we know what is the progress and how you must progress like that. He is now clerk, you know, from peon he moved prior. Then he used to enter in computer, sir, these many are given today like that. So that should be your effort, in fact. I'll come to that last. List of case studies, MBA particularly. How many case studies you have given? You say that every chapter or every topic you have given a case study, how many you have given? Do you have the teaching notes for case? Simply cannot throw on the students and tell you do it. No. Have you done first deliberations? Have you attempted all that? That will give you good heads over that. List of handouts. What are the handouts you have given? Suppose some topic you have found in, say, business line. I'm asking all of you are reading business line, economic time, some interesting thing you have found. Have you given that as a handout to your student? Saying that, come on, guys, this you read today, class I'll discuss. After the break, I'll discuss. Did you do that? Then you have to do that. Additional resources for student, other than textbook, other than net, what else you have given? Did you send somebody to Toyota, go and learn and come back? Suppose today you're teaching continuous manufacturing process. Like that it is. How good the reputation you have got with the industry, that matters a lot here. Material for problem-based learning. Have you given enough material for problem-based learning? IA marks, be careful with IA marks. I think this VTU is much better. But you need to have, when you give an IMR, you should have a copy with you. If you don't take printout, I don't advise you to take printout, at least in your system, and proper folder, year-wise, 2018-19, 2021, I taught these many subjects, these many internal marks. And you need to know that, you need to do a small check after the result is out, compare between the internal marks and the external marks. Simply, you cannot, I know the student, she looks beautiful, I give 20 out of 25, no. That is not the way. There are a lot of issues here. My learned teachers must really use this as a good weapon for bringing out talent in the students. Simply don't do that otherwise. These are all few samples I brought. I have no time for all this. Whatever in processes after students undertaking forum, we have the undertaking forum, right? Then that bond also you take, no? The anti-ragging, 50 rupees bond and all that. You have to keep it properly, along with the list there, signed by that. Model-wise feedback review, parent-teacher meeting, PTA meeting you're conducting, at least announced. Even one parent can come, but did you announce?
Yes.
Where is the timetable for that? In your timetable, in your calendar of event, you must mark it. After the first test, we have one parent-teacher meeting, and that you have to establish a document for that. Maybe the 10 parents may come, you don't know. You never tried, but you can't say that parents will not come. Parents may come. They want to know the progress of their children. Department meeting. Are you doing department meeting?
Yes,
proper documents available?
Yes,
okay, course file. I told you on the course file, what are the documents to be in the course file. Department academic audit. I was mentioning to somebody while planning up. So one department can go and do audit of the other department before you upload on the system. What I want is, VBT should get A++, best grade. I think you'll get it because you have a lot of things in place. Placement, pre-placement profiling, have you done? Pre-placement manual, have you produced any manual, rules, regulation? I am the brightest in the class. I got 5 company job. What you are going to do? You are not sending me, are sending me, allowing me in 6th company also? Who is placement officer? But they should know this. So they should have the record for this, proper record. Suppose I have got 5 company selected. 6th one, are you allowing me? What will happen to this one who has not got even one? What is the policy on that? What is the placement policy? Whatever it is, 2 or 1 or whatever it is. They should have proper manual for that. Any buddy system is there? You have bright shield in the class. Usually it happens. I can still remember some of my old students of our batch who used to conduct a class like Vishwa. He used to conduct a class. He's a rank holder, BTU first batch rank holder. Okay. He used to conduct a class for those who are weak in that particular thing. Remember this? That's how it is. Buddy system, is there available? Student development programs, what are the programs you designed for students? Gifted students, do you have any gifted students? You have to do that. Industry and campus, if you are not able to go, can you call the industry here itself? Industry persons, basically. Student project and internships, how best is your student project? Are you conducting any competition? You can do that. Here are about 5-6 engineering colleges are there. Call for best project report competition. So we are making our students more, you know, vibrant. So therefore, when they go to job, they'll do good there and they bring good name to you. That is more interesting here. Student paper, M.Tech and MBA student must paper present elsewhere. Next, innovative project zone, overall placement statistics. That is required because if you look at quantitative and qualitative, when you log on, you will get when your institute is registered in NAC, they'll give you all these tables. That time, all this is required. Student placement, then companies visited campus, that list is required. Patents, any patents? Patents if you're in pipeline, that all will come. I think somebody was telling mention something is there. Publication come area, this area, overall publication summary, journals, international, national, how you have done, what you have done. I give an understanding by Professor Renuka Murthy that you have got a good journals here. Conferences, books chapters, teaching reports, technical reports, sorry, research thesis, all that. Okay. Next, proposals, are you writing proposals? Please write, whether you get money or not, that is a different issue. Do you have the ability to write a proposal? That is more important now. Having done PhD, most of your PhD here, do you have the competency? If not, learn. Ask somebody who has done earlier. Nothing wrong in learning from others. Funded research project, how many are funded? How many research proposal schemes? MODROVE, DST, etc. Just a few I mentioned. Have you conducted any training for industry? Somebody can plan. How many collaborations you have done? These are proposal area it is. Infrastructure, I think you have. Lessons, softwares are there. Equipments, peripherals, networking, teaching aids, central library. These are all things required in infrastructure. Results, overall result analysis, result extracts, program topper, rank since inception. You should have at least now 5 badges have gone, 5 rank holders. One name should be available with you. Distinctions awarded, merit scholarships, anything. Identity, how you get your identity, you faculty members, please see that, you can do this. How many of your BOS members, how many of your BOS chairman, BOE members, chairing sessions, faculty invitation, you must get at least one or two invitations so that you won't tell everybody VTU regional center mice, VTU regional center mice, so that you get recognition. Identity, identity has to be established by you, not by anybody. It's all your work it is. How many vocational training programs, NSS, NCC, departmental college fest, do you conducted any fest so far? If not conducted, start the program. MOUs, there are a lot of time available. Don't tell me there is no time. Only thing you need to take interest. As a teacher, what is this? Teaching faculty list, faculty student ratio, non-teaching list, attrition rate ratio, faculty engagement form. Are you engaged full time? You know, every time you have marked, if the system is there. How much you are engaged? Where is your workload pattern? UT has got workload pattern, you know that, right? Then how much you engaged? Not 6 hours. Professor, 8 hours. Then assistant professor, 16 hours. Then how many counseling session, how many paper publication? There is a clear cut. When I was in PTU, I got the 20. I can share with you. PhD guidance, how many you are doing. Or additional duty. Manjunath sir has given some additional duty. Let us say NAC coordinator. For that, there are hours. The engagement should be proper. Otherwise, you are with no job. You may say that I am government, nobody can remove. That's fine. But you are underutilizing your talent. Look at this. You can involve in yourself in something else where you can be useful to the society. Individual faculty records, faculty resumes. Role of chairman, you all are bedaiga. One thing, caution for you guys. Institutions submitting fraudulent data or information will be debarred from the accreditation process and legal action initiated. It is not my words, it is there in RAF, Revised Accreditation Framework. clearly they mentioned this. So it's my duty to tell you, don't tell any false things. Always I to encourage, I do one day program, but however, confidence is the hardest thing to get, but easiest thing to lose. If I'm confident, yes, I can do it. Otherwise, no. This should be your target, because A double plus great. This Bill Gates says, I think you know about Bill Gates, recently was in news. Ask the experienced person how to start a work, but ask the successful person how to finish a work. To do this, anybody in life is also applicable to life, also applicable to individual. Anybody has done this? Anybody has planned in your life how to be failed? Plan versus fail. And where do you fail then? He who fails to plan is planning to fail. That's it. You are not planned it properly. Otherwise, you are a successful person or institute. Education. Education is not a degree or certificate that can be shown to others as a proof, marriage time or relationship time. No, it is our attitude. I think my learned colleagues must understand here, your attitude, your actions, your language, and your behavior with others in real life. The most learned person is most humble person. This is what education talks about, especially teachers. Because by default, people say good morning, good evening to all of us. By default, whether you deserve it or not. So you should not misuse. You have proper attitude, actions, plans, behavior with others in real life. The more you are benevolent, the more respect you get from others. Warning, sorry, I told you about this. Anyway, the chance to wish you guys Happy Independence Day in advance. Freedom, where is the freedom? Freedom in the mind, faith in the words, pride in our souls. Let's salute the nation in advance, and because tomorrow we'll not be meeting. So any questions, please? Any questions across web and faculty present here? Yeah, any questions, sir? Hello, sir. Yeah, I can take.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Namo Adibal, sir.
Hey, Adibal, please tell me.
Enappa?
Tell me, sir. Tell me. This is going to be there with technology. No problem. Tell me.
With respect to mentoring, see, most of
mentoring, correct.
Students for postgraduate entry, they are all almost all parents. See, how do you expect this one to mentor these such people?
Okay, good question. Though they entered the postgraduate program, however, still you need to identify who needs. One who is topper, one who is good in the class, don't need it. No need of doing mentoring. You have to identify as a teacher who needs mentoring. That is either by using some methods called maybe test marks or maybe any other method you can employ.
Sir, if we have completed 5-6 years of accreditation,
yes,
sir, that is 3 years SAR visit and another 3 years by compliance visit.
Okay.
What will be our next stage, sir?
No, you are talking about NAC, right?
No, sir, NBA, National Board of Accreditation, NBA.
Okay. First time, how many years you got?
3 years we got. Okay. After that, compliance visit was there.
Okay.
And we have got 3 years. After that, what is our next step, sir?
Is 6 years over?
Yes, sir. By 21 June, we will be completing 6 years.
Then you have to start now applying for again, no? Which program is that?
Once again, SAR only, sir. Mechanical engineering only.
Sir,
so once again, SAR only, we will update.
Yes, SAR. Yeah.
Sir, and here in this, I'm having one query, sir.
Yeah,
do we need to change our vision now? Because we are going for the next time.
Okay.
Do we need to change the vision and mission, sir?
See, very good question, ma'am. I must thank you for asking
this
question. Vision, mission.
Thank you, sir.
Vision, mission are like life. We grow each, grow each day, right?
Yes, sir.
We grow, everybody grow. Vision, mission is not constant. Vision, mission is change. There has to be change.
Okay.
10 years back, what my vision cannot be good today. It is a vibrant, because I say now COVID is in place, right?
Yes, sir.
60% of your classes may be online in future. Who knows?
Yes, sir.
your vision has to be changed. Vision mission is a vibrant one, live actually. There is life for them.
Okay, sir.
So 20 years back or 10 years back, what you made vision mission may not hold good today.
Okay, sir. Sir, it is only 6 years back, sir. Six years back,
you need to change, ma'am. Vibrant organizations are those who are updated with the latest things. They want to change.
Okay.
But there is a format for doing change.
Yes, sir.
Your HOD, your principal, and your faculty member need to sit together.
Yes, sir.
Various stakeholders sit together.
Yes, sir.
Analyze why do you need change.
Yes, sir.
There should be proper documentation you should establish for that. What calls for change in your vision mission?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Hello.
Yeah. Tell me, sir.
Hello.
Hello, sir. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, tell me. I'm audible. Yeah.
Hello, sir. It is nice presentation. Congratulations. I have one doubt regarding dropout ratio of the student. So in the student progression, earlier it was there.
Yeah.
But now if you look at the new criteria, there is no such any questions in the student progression criteria.
You're talking about
dropout ratio of the student.
See, earlier report it was there. In the new format you have seen?
Yes, sir.
Format where quantitative matrix and qualitative matrix are there,
yes,
right?
Sir. Yes, sir.
But how do you assess the success rate of your department then?
It is based on the result, but they have not mentioned any dropout ratio, but it was there in the earlier criteria.
Yeah, it was there, correct. You need to calculate 5 minus yes. 1, 2, 3 like that. That you know that. The formula, you know that. NBA formula.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. You are from which college? Which
I am from VTU MBA department.
Oh, nice. Okay, good.
I am Dr. Prahlad Rathod,
associate professor. Right.
Hello.
Okay, yeah.
Hello.
Thank you.
Namaste.
Thank
you. Hello.
Yeah. Sir.
Hello. Namaste,
yeah, yeah.
Sir.
Namaste.
I have two queries. One is regarding this, the intake sanctioned and, you know, the numbers admission realized.
Correct.
We know that both in NBA and in NAC, there are certain marks allotted to them.
Yeah.
But we wanted to know whether there any bar on that below 70% you are not able to apply. Or below 60% you are not, the institute is not eligible to apply.
Okay.
That is one question. I mean,
yeah.
With regard to both NBA and NAC, suppose I have got 120 intake.
Yeah.
I could not even able to realize 100 intake.
Yeah.
Then whether I am able to apply for that. Second question, probably I'll put this question also to you.
Yeah.
Regarding this CBS. Like,
CBC.
You know, choice-based credit system.
Yes, sir.
What is the essence of that? Like, you know, I mean, one credit for 7, 1 week. I mean, with regard to theory and the practical.
I got your question. Shall I answer the questions?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Both.
What is the, kindly affiliate yourself, which university or which college, which department you belongs to?
I am affiliated to VTU. I'm calling from Bangalore, East Point.
East Point. Okay, good. Okay. The thing is, you are engineering college, right?
Right.
There is one institute where governing or regulatory mechanism, I told in the beginning, there are two things you need to do. One is statutory regulation. Other one is regulatory mechanism, regulatory body. As far as engineering college is concerned, regulatory body is AACTE. AACT gives every year, depending upon facility available, faculty available, various criteria they have got, and then you get your intake sanctioned.
Correct.
Your question here is, if you are year on year, if you are not able to get the students, okay. Hello.
Yeah, yeah.
Year on year, you are not able to get the student means your department is not doing good. Demand is not there for the particular program.
Correct.
Okay. And moreover, in case of NAC, it is a combination of all the departments.
Good.
Therefore, as of now, they are not barred. If you have less admission, you cannot go like that. They are not barred.
Yeah.
Like you can also check once again the website. Number one.
Yeah.
Number two is, what is choice-based credit system? I can be more elaborate on this. Depending upon the nature of the course and then the gravity of the course. Suppose engineering college, first year, Mathematics, M1. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Sir, first of all, what is credit? It is a pretty preliminary, but I would like to mention. Credit means one contact hour per week is called one credit.
Correct. Okay. I mean, so it is applicable both for theory and lab.
No, that you have to decide. Suppose in case of MBA, there are no practicals for few of the subjects. Then we decide that one.
Good.
Basically, you need to combination and CBCS, you are affiliated to VTU. Therefore, VTU, they are doing this.
They are doing it.
So your role is to, even as an affiliated college, you are managing the things there. Already we made 3+1 or 2+2, whatever it is.
Yeah.
But you asked about what is the philosophy behind CBCS.
Yeah.
Having I taught in foreign university.
Yeah. What because there in foreign university, you have this. I mean, this more influence. Our universities are not coming into it.
Yeah. So now the course which is must for the students is usually how it goes, sir. One semester means it is about 16 weeks.
Correct.
Okay. So you get 16 weeks followed by roughly, then you'll have an evaluation pattern, then you have examination, all that numbers. One semester. If you look at your syllabus, there are hours they are mentioned there.
Correct.
Okay. So many hours has to be divided by number of weeks. Usually the 14 weeks we get.
Okay.
So therefore, how many contact hours you are? Suppose there is one course, some of the courses in VTU, they are non-credit courses, like Canada, like that, right?
Correct.
Some courses on constitution.
Non-credit.
Yeah. Yeah. Different terminology you can use. Some need not have the credit also. But still you can administer. Some you say must means your minimum credit is 4. 4 contact hours per week. It means 56 hours at least you must send during the course of the semester.
Okay.
Because your board of chairman studies will have enough knowledge on this. Which course we have 4 credit, which course we have 2 credit, because credit upper limit is given. A good engineering institute or a course is one where roughly between 175 to 200 credits should be there. In case of MBA, it is between 75 to 100 credits should be there. It is the prerogative of the chairman BOS who devises this particular thing. Okay. Though we say in VTU, tell me, sir, tell me.
But as a teacher, what should I be? Which way I should be more concerned? I mean, if I take a three credit system or a 5 credit course, as a teacher, which way I should be concerned with that, other than going to the class more time?
What subject you teach, sir? So I can take that as a reference and talk about it. Which subject? Which course you teach?
You know, metal cast.
Yeah.
What is called manufacturing metal cast.
Okay. Can you look at your affiliated college? You have a very less freedom here. That also should keep. However, as a good teacher is one. Can you make skill based in your subject? Can you go to the classroom with lot of PPT is basically one media where lot of hours you save. Earlier, you look at my teacher, your teacher, they used to 1 hour they used to speak, right? But now that can be condensed in 10 to 20 minutes. Remaining 20 minutes, can you make time useful to the students and learning? Can you put them into learning mode?
Correct.
See, the syllabus is the broad spectrum. The teacher, your teacher is the boss for entire course. But you should have a proper record for this, sir. Proper record. What kind of things you have done? Which is the theory portion? Which is practical portion? All that kind of thing.
Is it based on the importance? Is it based on the university has decided it? Based on the importance of the course?
Yes, because they need to look at the progression in second semester, what will happen in third semester, what will happen in PG, what will happen, like that. It is a depend. The BOS chairman will have the knowledge on what course to be in preliminary, what should be the credit. He decides that, along with assisted by other professors in the BOS.
Correct, sir.
Hello, sir. Hello, please speak.
Sir, this is Dr. Basavaraj.
Yeah.
From Visheshwara Technological University, Belagavi. Sir, I am the coordinator for the NAC accreditation process for VTU right now. Yesterday only. Sir, yesterday only we have uploaded IIQV and waiting for the response from the AICT, NAC authorities. Sir, it is a nice presentation. We gone through your presentation.
Is he paid?
Yes, we have paid fee. 29,500 rupees we have already paid. And just we are waiting for. There was one small query regarding the name of the university. It was a little bit earlier, it was different, and now it is a little bit different in the spelling of Vishwashwara. That clarification we have submitted yesterday.
Sir, there
are a lot of queries with me.
On this, I
think this is not a right platform to discuss all those things.
If at all,
I call you personally and seek your advices for some of the queries.
Sir,
can you please help us in this regard?
Oh, yes. Basavaraj, always I am.
Thank you, sir.
There are two sessions very difficult to handle, sir. One just before the lunch and one after the lunch. Everybody is hungry.
That's correct, sir. And we are going for the first cycle, sir. Yeah. University is going for the first cycle for accreditation. Oh. So a lot of documentation work and all things are pending right now. Because, see, a lot of activities have been done in the university, but documentation is not properly maintained. So we are trying to collect all those things and preparing the SSR and all that.
Sooner you get IAQA, okay. You are allowed to log on to various screen.
Yes, sir.
Please print out or share with your faculty member across the engineer, all the regional departments.
Okay.
You should know what is the question. When I say quantitative matrix and qualitative matrix, they should know what is qualitative and quantitative.
Sir, I think a lot of discussions have been made with the program coordinators and the chairmen of the departments on this NAC accreditation process. I had circulated all that quantitative and qualitative data templates also.
Okay.
And they have submitted a lot of information relating to that. Still, okay. We have not undergone a AAA analysis, sir.
Sir, yes.
We are trying to go for that after the IAQA and all that in between the process. Because still some things are pending. I think it is not mandatory. AAA is not mandatory, but still then we are doing it, sir, once before the time, because 45 days time is available with us.
Sir, that you must tell all the faculty members here, from the date of IAQA getting the date, there is a date of 45 days.
Everybody
should know that. Otherwise, they will miss on the date.
Yes, sir.
Because you should take everybody into account. It is a teamwork, sir, basically. It is a teamwork basically.
Definitely.
Take everybody's confidence because regional centers are in Mysore, Bangalore.
Yes, sir. It is very difficult to.
Because of
this COVID and all that, we cannot meet personally also. So all the things cannot be so easily clarified online and all that. But till then, we have done a lot of work on this, sir. A lot of information has been gathered so far.
Yeah.
Only on teaching, learning and evaluation process, we are little bit need to streamline the activities and get the documents and all that.
My number is with Professor Renuka Murthy here.
Yes, sir. So first of all, I thank Renuka Murthy for introducing you to all of us. And I thank Yatish Chandra also and Manjunath sir also for organizing this activity. Thank you very much.
Hope this session is informative and useful, right?
Yeah, 100%, sir. It is most useful. And all that manual is there with us. But still then there are a lot of queries. I need the advices of the experts like you.
Please, sir.
I disturb you a lot, sir, every evening on these aspects. Please bear with us. Thank you, sir.
There are two things happening. Either I'll make more money than any one of you, or I'll be disturbed always. It's time to say bye-bye. Shall I say bye-bye to everyone?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir.
Thank you
very much.
Sir, tell me. ಪರ್ಸನಲಿ ಕಾಂಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್
ಮಾಡಬಹುದು
ಮೈ ನಂಬರ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಮೋರ್ ಮನಿ
ಪ್ಲೀಸ್
9980
ಸಮಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಐ ಫೀಲ್
9980
ಪೀಪಲ್ ಐ ಯುಸ್ಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೇಷನ್ ಟು ಮೀಟ್ ಯು ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಿ 9980
very nice session sir myself professor kulkarni from bd gulbarga
so thank you kulkarni sir thank you
yeah sir it was very valuable information we have got through this session sir thanks a lot for your
thank you
very thorough knowledge about NACS sir
oh thank you sir the last 20 years I am in this line sir
yeah they should have identified people like you in the video
and I can render my service to anybody sir anytime no problem thank you sir and okay you are doing good
that was my feeling sir
no so it's still there I am there now only your activity starts now because windows will open now once your IAQA is passed IAQA means license like that it is
yeah
once that is done then you start filling the data in that required boxes I think Professor Basaraj is on that job.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Okay, so that you will share all the templates with you. Collecting data, collecting data, presenting data is a very critical issue, sir, here.
Where you house, sir? Yes, sir. Are you house in Mysore?
Sir? Yeah.
Are you house in Mysore?
I have house in Mysore, yes. Thank you guys. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Life is very easy. We are more talented, please.
Thank you, sir.
It's better to bring changes in your management.
Thank our regional director Dr. Manjunath, MBA chairperson Basavaraj Kutchimma, and our program coordinator Dr. Kishi Renka Mukti sir for their enthusiastic support. Thank you all. I, on behalf of Department of Management Studies, convey my heartfelt gratitude and sincere thanks to the e-learning center CPTS Mysore. Thank you. My heartfelt thanks to all the participants from different places for their active participation. Thank you all. I thank the coordinators of this program and my MBA team, CP Kadalman, and all the team members of the center for your unflinching support and for your thank you all. A special thanks to Manjula, Ravi Siddhaya, Sitaramu technicians and Ms. Saudanya assistant professor from company employment have greatly helped us in organizing the webinar. Thank you all. With these warm words and a kind message, we move to the end of today's webinar. Thank you. I request all the participants to fill the feedback form in order to receive your key sentiments. Thank you again. Have a nice day.